One. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to another great Maroon Devil football showdown. And tonight it could be the showdown of the year as our Maroon Devils are hosting the Elkin Bucking Elks here tonight at Swain County Memorial Stadium and Boyce Dietz Field in a game that's kind of a heavyweight rematch, if you will, in the 1A football standings across the state of North Carolina. As all Maroon Devil fans know, last year at Elkin, the Elks won a heartbreaker 24-22 for Maroon Devil fans. After that game, Elkin cruised to a state 1A championship. And we feel tonight another 1A state championship is going to be coming up after this one, as both these teams have rich football traditions and a lot is on the line tonight. But the Maroon Devils have that revenge on their mind after losing a tight two-point ball game last season in the cold rain at Elkin. Tonight it's clear and cold at Swain County, and Zimmerman kicks it high. He kicks it deep. It's going to be taken actually at the one-yard line, and Elkin is going to bring it out past the 10, and they're going to be stopped at the 14-yard line. And that's what Nick Zimmerman has been doing all season long, kicking it deep, not allowing much on the return game. As a matter of fact, Nick's kickoffs, 62% of them this year have been in the end zone. Many more inside the one before they're brought out. And Elkin is going to be dealing with that weapon all night long. Glad to be back again for more Maroon Devil football here on Hometown Television. And we are ready to rock and roll here tonight as the Devils will be on defense first. We won the toss and deferred to the second half as Elkin comes out running the football on the first play. They might have picked up 1 yard on the play as the Devil defense really, really converged. Jason Boston also on the tackle, Eric Stevenson. Eric and Jason, two of the leaders on this defense. Eric coming in with 58 tackles on the year. Jason with 54 tackles on the year, doing a good job inside. It's going to be second down now, and still almost 10 to go for the Elks here early in the first quarter. Again, weather conditions perfect for what we like to call mountain football, cold and clear. And we can see the middle of the field is still a little bit on the damp side, if you will, kind of worn in certain spots of the field here tonight. And out to the left side. Great run over on the left side out to the 22-yard line as the Maroon Devils, Jason Boston and company, provide the hit. One guy really got stuck. Justin Evans really got a hit by the Elkin running back on that particular play. It's going to bring up third down now and three for Elkin. 10:51 to go. We're in the first quarter now from Swain County Memorial Stadium. The winner of this game will play in Raleigh's Carter-Finley Stadium next Saturday, or this Saturday as you listen to this game on delayed broadcast. Left side, nowhere to go for Elkin, and it's going to bring up a fourth down for the Elks now. Good surge in the middle by the Maroon Devil defense. Especially over there by number 34, Jason Boston, as he stopped Chris Martin, the tailback, on the play. So it's 34, knocking down 34, as now Elkin will have to punt. And back deep, a very dangerous duo for the Maroon Devils. Back deep, we're going to be having some guys who can bring it back. One of those is going to be Stephen Mercer. Over on the other side, it's going to be Josh Anthony. Nice punt by Elkin. Anthony at the 39 gets a block and brings it back out to the 44-yard line, where the Devils will take over first and 10 with 9:57 to play here in the first quarter. Up county have reporters from Swain County Radio, from Elkin Radio, from the Asheville Citizen tonight. We're glad to have Jacob Messer here on the press box with us. Asheville Citizen has provided some excellent newspaper coverage of Swain County football in the past couple of weeks, and the folks here in Swain County have really enjoyed it. Scotty McMahon to throw on first down, and he is in trouble and is going to be sacked on the play. And that hasn't happened very much in the entire playoff series this year. Scotty is going to be dropped, spotting the football at just shy of the 37-yard line. So Elkin putting heat on Scotty McMahon on the first play. Scotty very instrumental in that game last year at Elkin, as he had a very solid football game, along with Cody White, Justin Evans, and many more players. All the juniors, 19 of them who were seniors now, remember the Elkin game very well tonight from last year. Scotty hands off right side. Maroon Devils stay on the ground. This is going to be Cody White. And what a year Cody White has had, as he's going to be knocked down over there on the play. But Cody White brought down by Keith Whitman, a 5'11 sophomore, very young Elkin team. That's the major difference in the team that was dominated by seniors last year It's the exact opposite. Tonight, the Maroon Devils dominated with 19 seniors. On the flip side, Elkin only four seniors on this team that is very young, but they're very good, coming in 11-3 as the number three seed here in the Western Division. Third down now, McMahon rolling, looking, throwing on the run. It's going to be caught, and it's going to be short of the first down, though, at the 47-yard line. Just a yard short on a nice catch on the comeback by Josh Anthony. And I would think without a doubt our Maroon Devils are going to go for it on fourth down and a yard. So not something the Devils have really had a problem with this year. Justin Evans going back in. And down on the sideline, Devin Smathers trying to crank up the crowd as offensive coordinator Steve Manley calls the play. Going in, it's going to be Scotty McMahon. He wants to come back and make sure. And these guys are going to have to, well, they have plenty of time. Still over 15 seconds on the play clock here. So no reason to be in any hurry. Take your time. Get the call right. Get the play right. Fourth down and a yard at the Elkin 47-yard line. Two backs behind Scotty McMahon now as he tosses to the left side. Cody has the first down and then some. Breaks into the secondary. Look out down the sideline. Cody White all the way in. Maroon Devil touchdown. That one coming from about 47 yards away. 47 yards unofficially by Cody White. And that is kind of a play that erases some bitter memories from last year at Elkin High School. So the Devils jump on top first with 7:38 to play in the first quarter, 6-0. Nick Zimmerman, who has been deadly from anywhere on the field. Last week we saw a 44-yard field goal by Nick, and he has the potential to do a lot of things kicking the football. This one is going to be up, and it's going to be good. What else is new for Nick Zimmerman? So with 7:38 to play in the first quarter, the Devils strike first, 7-0 over Elkin.
Number one, Wesley Martin. Number 34, Chris Martin. And number 62, Terry Adams. The D backs receive Zimmerman's second kickoff.
Welcome back as the Devils get set to kick it back to Elkin. We stopped them the first time, we scored, and now Nick Zimmerman back in action and another booming kick into the back of the end zone as the Maroon Devils again put Elkin at the 20-yard line, 80 yards away from pay dirt. And as Rod White said in an interview earlier this week in the Asheville newspaper, he said, anytime you put a team at the 20 and make them drive 80 yards, it's definitely a disadvantage for the offense. And that gives this Maroon Devil defense, which has been so impressive all year, a leg up. Our Devil defense giving up only 8.8 points per game while scoring 45.6 on the offensive side of the sticks. First down now. A touchback at the 20 as Elkin takes over in the I formation. They hand off to the left side. Jason Boston on the tackle. Boston comes storming in. Knocks number 34 down again. That's 34 again. Chris Martin, a 5'10 junior, weighs only 160 pounds. So Boston has about 40 pounds on him from the size advantage, and Boston just knocked him down for no gain. And that's going to bring up second and 10 now with 7:15 to play here in the first quarter. We'll talk more about the differences in these two teams here as the first quarter goes on. But again, Elkin, not the team that beat us last year. We'll see if that proves true on the scoreboard. Toss to the right side now. Trying to turn the corner. It's going to be number 34 again. Again, that's Chris Martin, and he's knocked down for only a short gain. Good tackle over there by Cody White. Also over there is going to be Justin Evans. Also on the stop is Eric Stevenson. This defense, again, playing tough football here tonight. But talking about Elkin, they're missing some of their big guns from last year. Justin Billups, who had over 3,000 yards, gone. Patrick Humphreys, the number two back, gone. Their top two receivers from last year, gone. Their quarterback from last year is now a wide receiver. So a much different offense Elkin throws at us here tonight. Their quarterback rolls to the left side. Right-hander throws down the field, and he overshoots his man, who had a little room down there. Ben Crosswhite had a little opening down there, but the quarterback threw it too close to the sideline. It's going to be incomplete, bringing up third down and nine now for the Bucking Elks of Elkett High School. And that's easy for me to say. So right now, fourth down and nine. Elkin is going to have to punt it back for the Maroon Devil offense. Keith Whitman, who's a linebacker on defense, is coming on to punt. He's only a sophomore.
punting number 24, Keith Whitmer.
And again, back deep for the Maroon Devils, we have, looks like, Stephen Mercer. Along with him, Josh Anthony, who's truly a big play guy on offense and defense. Anthony with 7 interceptions this year on defense. Kind of an end-over-end punt, not the best of the year by Elkin, and a penalty flag is down. It goes out of bounds near the 45-yard line, but a penalty flag is down, the first flag of the night. Last week, if the Maroon Devils had anything at all that was in the negative column, it was penalties. We were charged with 82 yards in penalties. This penalty is illegal procedure against Elkin. Obviously, it's going to be declined by the Maroon Devils, and we get the football in great field position at the 45-yard line with 6:08 to play here in the first quarter. As Coach Rod White said last week, one of our main goals is to establish our will against Elkin. And so far, the Maroon Devils are doing that against the Bucking Elks here in the first quarter. First down, great field position at the 45-yard line of Elkin territory. Scotty and company setting up the offense. We might have had a guy move on the offensive line. No flag is down, though, and it's going to be trouble for the running game. Elkin strung that one out really well as Casey Shuler had nowhere to go, and Elkin played sideline to sideline. Good technique football. But Elkin, great year on the last couple of years. They've won the last two state 1A championships in 2002 and 2003. Their men's tennis team won the state championship in 2003, and their wrestling team won the state championship in 2003. So the Elkin teams were blessed with great athletes the past couple of years. Let's hope it's Swain County's turn this year. Second down and 10. And this time it's going to be a great hole again, as all the way down inside the 30 is going to be Cody White. Cody White, as we mentioned, came in with a special vengeance against Elkin. As you know, Cody had a big fumble in that ball game last year. And a lot of folks said, hey, that was a big play in the game. It was. But there were so many big plays in that ball game last year at Elkin. We'll talk more about those as the game progresses. That's a big first down for Cody, who already has one touchdown run tonight. And that's the difference on the scoreboard. 7-0 with 5.5 minutes to play in the first quarter here. Elkin right now with a bunch of guys in the box. 8 men up there tied against the Maroon Devil offense. Toss to the left side. It's going to be Cody White again. He's got some room again at the 20. Down to the 15. Inside the 15, Cody White with another Maroon Devil first down. Cody, a great year running the football this year. 166 carries, 1,294 yards. Averages a whopping 7.8 yards a carry and has scored 25 touchdowns on the ground. So Cody White in a great year and plays pretty good defense, too. 61 tackles, leads the team in tackles for losses with 13. So Cody White playing for his dad and doing a great job his senior season. He wants to win tonight probably more than anybody. Handoff straight ahead. It's going to be Casey Shuler, and big Casey bulls his way inside the 10-yard line to near the 8. It's going to bring up second down and about 4. And when we say big, Casey Shuler is a large lad at 5'11", 236, and he's only a junior. So he'll be one of the keys in the Maroon Devil football picture next year. We have 19 seniors, 10 juniors. So the juniors move up to lead the team next year. But this year, one of the greatest senior classes we have ever had in Swain County football history. Our tight end lines up on the right side. Strong right. The toss goes to the right side. Casey cuts back. Good tackle over there. Guy grabbed him by the leg at the 11 and drags him down as he got back to the line of scrimmage. It's going to bring up a third down, and we'll call it about 5. Third down and almost 5. Talking about Elkin, they're giving up 14.9 points a game. Their defense pretty stingy this year. They're averaging a little over 28 points a game offensively. And let's see if the Maroon Devils can dethrone the Elks here tonight. They've won the last two state championships in a row. Scotty McMahon over center now on third down. Got a man in motion, Justin Evans. Handoff goes to Cody White inside the 5. It's another first down. Cody White keeps moving the chains, and the chain gang on the sideline is happy to see that. Kind of chilly down there as well on the sideline. On the tackle over there is a Tyler Trunso and company on the stop for Elkin.
First and goal, Maroon.
3:36 to go, first quarter. The Devils lead it 7-0, on the verge of adding more on the scoreboard here. Four downs to go, 4 yards. And with the averages of people like Cody White and Casey Shuler and Eric Stevenson, doesn't take many plays to pop it in there. Let's see what happens. Cody gets the call. Right side, he is in. Touchdown, but hold the phone. A flag is down. And normally when it's in that territory, it's probably a holding call on the offense. And let's see if that's the case. That can really sting. That's going to bring up a first and nine. So instead of first and goal at the 4, instead of the touchdown that Cody White just scored, we're going to move back to the 9 and call it first down again. But again, talking about the Elks last year, a couple of block punts were big in the first half as Elkin's Adam Weatherman blocked a Swain punt, giving Elkin the ball on Swain's 21-yard line. From there, they kicked a 25-yard field goal. And then a second block punt in the first half. Terry Adams crashed through and blocked a punt. And that was recovered in the end zone to give Elkin a 16-0 lead. Two special teams block punts were huge in that game last year. Tight end tied on the left side now. First down.
He still got it.
Scotty, you know, he hands off up the middle and getting some tough yards. Knocked down at the 7-yard line is going to be Cody White. Also on the tackle is going to be Keith Whitman. Keith Whitman, a busy, busy guy on offense, or on defense, rather. Keith Whitman, the linebacker. So just inside the 7-yard line. It's going to bring up second and goal there with 3:19 to play. Coming in with the play is going to be Jason Boston, who plays defense and also lines up some on the tight end spot on offense. He lines up tight on the right side now, as now the Maroon Devils go with a power set. Hand off left side. It's going to be Stevenson. Is he in? Yes. Eric Stevenson bangs it into the end zone. That's the first time we've seen that offensive set tonight for the Maroon Devils, and it paid off. So offensive coordinator Steve Manley with a good call, and the Devils lead 13-0 with 3:17 to play in this first quarter. Zimmerman on to kick the extra point after touchdown. And number one is good. It's a good number for him because he's had a lot of number ones this year. He's now 116 out of 123 in his career. And the extra point is going to be good again for Nick Zimmerman, hitting over 94% of those. 14-0, Devils lead over Elkin. We'll be back. Welcome back, fans, here on Hometown Television. Tonight's playoff game being professionally videotaped using professional 3-chip cameras, wireless microphones, and play-by-play by the only guy they could find. So, hey, we're off and running as Zimmerman kicks this one high and very short and out of bounds. Not his best kick of the year, so the Elkin Bucking Elks might have their best field position of the night. And don't forget now, a lot of pregame interviews that make this football broadcast a lot of fun. A portion of the proceeds from tape sales comes back to the Maroon Devils. So enjoy the game for years to come and support our team. Orders will be ready for pickup by Friday, or for $5, you can have it mailed to you. And because of the support of area businesses, cost for DVD or VHS tape is only $15. And thanks to all the Devil TV broadcast boosters. So contact Tammy Mincy, 497-6435. Kent or Cheryl Maxey at 488-1155. And also be watching here on Hometown Television for the Bryson City Christmas Parade broadcast. That is coming up this week as well. First down and 10, Elks at the 35. Their best field position on a kickoff tonight. They're looking for the big one. Throwing it down the field. It's going to be possibly picked off. Great defense down there by Justin Evans. Also on the defense is going to be Josh Anthony. They knock it down, but a tall wide receiver down there tried to pull it in, and he couldn't. As well, Stewart, 6'2", junior, had the size but couldn't pull it in. And that's one thing about our pass defense. It gets the job done. Talking about Josh Anthony, he has 7 interceptions this year. And I think he had number 8 in his mind on that particular play. 3:09 to go, first quarter. Devils up 14-0, but don't get too happy yet. More about that in just a moment. The quarterback is in trouble as the defense got to him. Dusty Lossie, Earl King on the sack as the quarterback feels the teeth of the Devil defense. Tyler Transu not giving any time. But talking about being up in a lead as the Devils are up 14-0. If you think back to last year, and we'll talk about that a lot tonight, Elkin got on top 16-0 in that ball game. And as you remember, the Maroon Devils stormed back to make it a 24-22 game. So a 16-0 lead maybe doesn't mean as much as you think. If we go back and reflect on last year's game at Elkin, quarterback back to throw again, rolling to the left side, has time, now throws, it's up for grabs, and it's going to be knocked away. Good defense. And that's number 34, Jason Boston. Boston, good defense because the pass was close. The quarterback running to his left, throwing down that sideline, a tough pass anyway. And Jason with the defense, forcing Elkin to punt again. So Elkin not threatening yet to get on the scoreboard here in the first quarter. 2:25 to play, but both teams mixing it up. A lot of run, a lot of pass. But the defensive edge goes to Swain County here in the first quarter. 14-0 now. Low snap, but he gets it. And it's going to be another sideline-type punt. It's going to be brought back this time on the run by Stephen Mercer. Mercer back to the 45-yard line and cracked down right there. Good tackle over there by number 21, Levi Carter. Carter on the stop, and that's going to bring up first down again in great field position, almost the same place we got the football last time, just inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. But again, talking about the great career of Nick Zimmerman, 117 out of 124 in his career in extra points, a little over 94%. And he has great academics on his mind, especially the Air Force Academy. So good luck to Nick. In the next step, Scotty McMahon, quarterback keeper, down to the 42, got a couple of yards. But Scotty has run the ball very well this year. He's passed it well, but running the football, he's had a great year. 82 carries, 396 yards on the ground, and he has scored 8 touchdowns rushing. And that's maybe the difference this year. Scotty McMahon has matured tremendously as a quarterback. Last year, he did a great job in the Elkin game, but this year he has performed just flawlessly. For example, in the passing department, Scotty has passed 123 times this year and only 2 interceptions. That's a stat anybody at any level would love to have. Got a man in motion. Scotty, he's going to run the option to the right side. He's going to keep it. He is going to be very close to a first down at the 34-yard line. So talking about the running and the decision-making of Scotty, that's probably the big improvement. Running the option and the veer that Coach Rod White and Coach Manley like to run on offense, you've got to have a good decision-maker. And Scotty has been extremely talented in that department this year. They're going to call it third down and less than a yard now with a minute to play in the first quarter. Devils up 14-0. But with a team like Elkin, when you've got them down, you want to keep them down. As Coach White says, we got to keep establishing our will on the other guys. Man in motion again. This time handoff to the left side. Cody with a first down and then some to the 31-yard line. So Cody White adding to his rushing total. As you know, the winner of this game moves on to the State 1A Championship game at Carter-Finley Stadium this Saturday coming up at high noon. They will play the winner of the Southside-North Side game. In the first quarter in that game, Southside looks to be a big favorite. They lead Northside 12-0. Southside ranked number 1 in the Massey Power Poll in the state. They have a tremendous football team. First down and 10. Just shy of the 30. Scotty to throw. Timing pattern left side, and it's going to be out of bounds. The chain crew, the chain walkers, fence walkers was what I'm trying to say. The fence walkers almost pulling that one down and almost got the cameraman on the sideline down there. So, again, a lot of great media coverage here tonight, the biggest press box crew we've had all season long. And it's great to have the coverage, and that's what happens when you have a great season, like our Devils who are coming in 12-0 and the number 1 seed in the Western Division. A great, great season. But also good luck tonight to Asheville and T.C. Robertson. respectively. They are playing some great schools in their playoff game tonight as well. Second and 10 now after the incomplete pass. Scotty turns, fakes the handoff. He's in trouble, got pressure. He rolls, he throws, and it's going to be picked off at the 27-yard line. Back to the midfield stripe. Elkin, good job on defense. Picking it off is going to be Tyler Transo. And Transo brings it back. Scotty saw his man, but he was well covered. So that one forced in there a little bit, and Elkin makes us pay, bringing it back to the 48-yard line. So from the 48-yard line, 12 and a half seconds to play in the first quarter. Time for one, maybe two more plays. But the Devils again, feeling the turnover sting. The Elks having a tough time now, trying to get anything going on offense. They line him up with two wide to the right side. The quarterback looking to the right side, throws, timing pattern, right side, has a man, and it's picked off. Here comes Mercer. Stephen Mercer on the pickoff back to the 49-yard line. So Stephen Mercer with a big play on defense. And our defensive secondary has been there all year long. Jason Boston, three picks. Also, Josh Anthony with seven picks. And the first pick tonight. Now, 3 seconds to play in the first quarter. Let's see if they start the clock. And if they do, we probably won't run a play. So now, a big play. Two back-to-back interceptions. Elkin caught one. We got it right back. Two interceptions in a row. So now they're going to wait till the ball snaps to start the clock. We'll get one play in before the end of period number one. Tight end strong on the right side. Mercer comes in motion after a big interception. A little misdirection and the handoff to Stevenson, but not much room to go as the first quarter comes to an end. The Devils lead Elkin 14 to nothing. Lead 14-0 after one. If we continue this, the scoreboard's going to be nice at the end of the ball game. But hey, this is Elkin. Nothing is taken for granted now. The Devils have the football back. Moment ago, back-to-back interceptions. Elkin got one. We got it right back on the next play. Toss to Cody White, and he's going to be stopped for a loss on the play. Back at the 47-yard line. Cody White, just a moment ago, had six carries for 93 yards. Might have lost a yard there, but Cody White is definitely headed for a 100-yard-plus rushing night tonight. Elkin giving up some points this year, 14.9 on defense, but they don't break. They score 28.3 on the offensive side of the football. Talking about Cody White after one, seven carries, 98 yards, averaging 14 yards a pop. That's a great first quarter. So he's going to be over 100 very soon. Scotty back to throw. He's hit from behind. He's got his man down the right sideline. Justin Evans forced out of bounds over there. Good defensive play by Hagan Miller. Miller forced him out of bounds. Miller, one of only four seniors on this team for Elkin. Elkin coming in on the season 11-3. Their only losses coming to Forbush 20-7, Salisbury 21-10, and Starmount 15-7 on the year. So good team again, number three seed out of the West. So now the Maroon Devils with a nice pass down to Justin Evans at the Elkin 35. We line him up tight on the left side, and we hand off and run that way as well. On the carry is going to be Eric Stevenson. Eric having a good night tonight as well. Talking about that interception a moment ago by Stephen Mercer. That was Stephen's first interception of the season. By a secondary that has a bunch of them. Second down now, eight to go from the 33-yard line of Elkin. Scotty McMahon looking to the right side. Coming in with a play over there is going to be Bobby Woods, another of the 19 seniors on this very talented and experienced Maroon Devil football team. All these seniors remember the heartbreak of that 24-22 loss last year at Elkin. And they want revenge here tonight. Hand off right side. For a couple of tough ones down to the 30-yard line, Elkin, tough in the middle. And on the tackle is going to be, let's see, number 32 among others on the stop, Cole Faulkner on the Elkin defense. So now let's call it third down and five. Just underway, second quarter now. Devils up by 14. We have given up only one touchdown this year on the playoffs. That was last week against Hobton. They broke one big run and scored a few seconds later. Those are the only points scored against this Devil defense throughout this playoff series. So now the Devils tied on the left side. Fake the handoff. Scotty rolls, cuts back inside. He's got pressure, breaks another tackle down to the 25. But from here, he looks to be a hair short. Depending on the spot. Boy, this is close. They might measure this one, guys and girls. This one is going to be close. The official looks to the sideline. And nope, not even going to measure, huh? Fourth down. They say fourth down and inches, and our Devils are going to go for it. There was never a question about that. But we need a few inches to get a new set of downs to play with here tonight against the Bucking Elks of Elkin in their gold and blue. Handoff left side. Cody spins for the first down and then some. Cody White on that carry goes over 100 yards on the night as he gets 5 to the 20-yard line. So Cody White spinning for 5. And as we mentioned, nobody may be as motivated tonight as Cody White to have a big ball game, and he's already over 100 yards on the ground. Splitting out wide to the left side is Josh Anthony. Officially now, Cody White, 107 yards on the ground tonight with 8:41 to play in the second quarter. Split back, Scotty turns and hands. Cody again, nice hole at the 10, down to the 5, and he's in the end zone. Is there a flag anywhere? No, we don't see one. This one's going to be good. And that is Cody's second touchdown tonight. As we mentioned, a lot of motivation in the heart of number 5 tonight. 8:32 to go in the first half. 20-0. Nick Zimmerman can make it 3-for-3 on this PAT. Nick's a fun guy to talk to. He's quite an intelligent young man. Good chance to be valedictorian this year at Swain County High School. Ooh, I think Elkin might have blocked that one. The kick was very low, hit the crossbar, and somebody might have got a hand on that PAT. But regardless, the Devils are up 20-0, 8:32 to play. We'll be back. Maroon Devils get to kick it off again to Elkin here. A lot of time left in the first half. 8.5 minutes to go here. And a 20-0 Devil lead. And Zimmerman kicks this one almost back to the field house. I think he was angry because that extra point was no good last time. But anyway, don't forget now, Bryson City Christmas Parade is going to be broadcast this week on Hometown Television. So be sure and tune in for the Bryson City Christmas Parade. You might get to see yourself, okay? And tonight's playoff game is being professionally videotaped using professional 3-chip cameras, wireless microphones, and play-by-play by yours truly. It'll also include pregame comments from Coach White, among others, and a portion of the proceeds go back to Swain County High School. Straight ahead, Elkin on the ground, about 9. And we might have a loose football, they say. And the officials might say otherwise. They say it's going to be Elkin football, so don't get excited. But as we mentioned, be sure and get your tape. Because of the support of area businesses, cost for DVD or VHS tape is only $15. You can have it mailed to you for $5. Just call Tammy Mincy, 497-6435, Kent or Cheryl Maxey, 488-1155. Get your tape. And thanks to all Maroon Devil TV supporters. Handoff right side, penalty flag down. Haven't seen many yellow hankies tonight, and that's a good thing. We saw enough last week to last a while. We were penalized 82 yards. That was the only thing we did wrong last week as we pounded Hobton. And I think it was just being pumped up and over-aggressive as We had some of those last week. Our guys were fired up and coming off the line in a hurry all night long. And as the Hopton coach said after the game, the Maroon Devil offensive and defensive lines control the football game, and he was right. Moving back five, the Bucking Elks of Elkin. And they're gold and blue. It's going to bring up first down at about 15 now with 8 minutes to go in this second quarter. Throwing on the run, the quarterback, and it's knocked down and almost intercepted by Josh Anthony. Anthony has 7 on the season. He almost got number 8 right there. He stepped up, and he could see nothing but end zone, I think, on that play. ...25-yard return for a touchdown. Remember now, hopefully the Maroon Devils will be playing at Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh Saturday at 12 noon. We hope you'll make the trip if things go as they're going tonight. Hand off left side. The Elks carry all the way out to the 30-yard line. It's going to be number 34, Chris Martin, a junior, on the bottom of the pile. Let's see who gets up. It's going to be Big Dusty Lossie, among others. Also Cody White on the stop and Jason Boston. Lossie is he's a big guy out there. Dusty, a senior, 6'4", 295. And the guy's in shape because he plays on both sides of the line, offense and defense. And he is quite an anchor on both sides and technique. He gets it done both ways. One spread each way now for Elkin. Rolling to the right, it's going to be the quarterback, Transo. And he throws. It's going to be complete. Just a short gain at the 34-yard line. Catching the pass over there is going to be Ben Crosswhite. It's going to bring up fourth down, though, and Elkin's going to have to punt it back to the Maroon Devils. And right now, the Elkin offense has not been successful. They've moved the ball a little bit here and there, but nothing consistent on offense as the Devil defense is just shutting down the Elks on offense. 7:10 to go now. We get the ball back here. Not a big rush, low snap. Line drive kind of punt. It's going to be picked up at the 39-yard line. Stepping up, nice return over there by number 25, Stephen Mercer, and gets a few on the return. So the Devils, wait a minute, we've got a penalty flag down. Let's see what this is about.
Flag on the play.
But we're going to get it in pretty good field position unless we get stung with a big penalty here. In the second quarter now, 7:03 to go. 20-0 Maroon Devils, our score. And the penalty is going to be charged for holding on the return team, so we are going to have to back it up a little bit. So instead of up across the 40, now we're back at the 30. But again, our Maroon Devils have been very effective on offense. Scotty McMahon bringing it in. Gets the call from offensive coordinator Steve Manley. And what a great job our coaches have done all season. Rod White, Steve Manley, Billy Jenkins, Frank Manley, Tommy Dills, Chuck Collins, James Phillips, Neil Blankenship, Travis Stevenson, Mike Treadway, Michael Watson, and the handoff coming right up the middle. Other coaches, Jeff Marr, Trey Burns, and Craig Barker. All those guys getting it done. Casey Shuler on the carry, knocked down on the play by, looks like, Terry Adams. Terry Adams, a big kid, 6'2", 230, a junior. Not quite as big as Leonard Jordan, though, 6'2", 280. But again, Elkin, basically a team that's looking ahead. Only 4 seniors on this team, but a good class of sophomores and juniors coming up in Elkin territory, about 3.5 hours away. Devils stay on the ground again, and again, only a couple out to the 35-yard line as Cody White bangs into the Elkin line. And there on the tackle is going to be number 70, Matt Nixon. Matt Nixon, 5'10", 220, a junior. And, you know, it wouldn't surprise me at all if we ran into Elkin again next year. Our Maroon Devils are going to have some guys coming up. Elkin could be a tough team next year as well. These guys, Coach Richard Grissom and Coach Rod White, excellent at getting the most out of their players. Oh, Scotty's in trouble. He's sandwiched, and the ball is loose. Getting on it, though, is a Maroon Devil jersey, number 75. Ian McCauley recovers the football, but I'm not sure. Scotty might have been down anyway. He hit the ground, but there is Ian McCauley to recover the football just in case it was a fumble. So for the first time tonight, I believe, we're going to have to punt it. So now we're going to punt, and on is going to be, it's like Devin Smathers on to punt. Big rush by Elkin. They love to block punts. Nice punt by Smathers. Fair catch. And no return there, surprisingly, by Hagen Miller for Elkin. But they get it in good shape with 5:10 to go here in the second quarter.
45-yard line. First and 10, Elkin on the Elks 45.
Frost, pretty thick frost all week, and looks like tonight is no difference here in the first weekend of December coming up here. And hopefully the second weekend of December, we'll be playing for a State 1A title in Raleigh. Handoff left side as the Elks run to the 49-yard line. A gain of almost four on the play. Looks like number 62, Earl King, on the tackle. Earl King, good to see back in there after having injury problems. Earl getting the job done in the middle along with Jason Boston. Jason, another guy, senior, that's played 3 years and been doing a great job. Second down, we'll call it six for Elkin. 4:42 to play. We're in the second quarter here from Swain County Memorial Stadium. Back to throw is going to be Transo. The quarterback throws right side, has his man. First down, quick feet to the 35, all the way to the 30-yard line. Nice job. Finally, dragging him down is going to be Steven Mercer on the tackle. So Mercer on the stop.
Brought down by Mercer.
So all the way to the 30, Elkin. And that may be their best field position of the night. Starting to threaten here just before halftime with 4:27 to play. 20-0 is our score, though. Maroon Devils on top. Elkin has not had the joy of being on the scoreboard yet. In the I formation now, the Elks line them up. They fake. The quarterback tosses, and there's a loose football in the backfield, and the Devils have it at the 33-yard line. It looks like Eric Stevenson might have it. Let's see as they all unpile. So a great play and a bad toss. And getting on it is Eric Stevenson. Stevenson on the football with 4:09 to play. Again, Transo tossed it to the right side. It never made a connection with his tailback. And so we have our second turnover tonight. We have one interception tonight, and now we recover the football. So Elkin on their best drive tonight is going to be shut out on this drive, and the Devils get the football back. So Steven Mercer wide to the right side now. Scotty tosses to the right side. It's going to be big Casey Schuler. He gives a stiff arm, and he knocks him down. Casey at the 45-yard line. What a stiff arm. He put a hand right in the face of Keith Whitman, and the stiff arm got him a first down. And that's something a lot of guys don't use as much as they used to back in the days of Jim Brown and some of those great running backs. A stiff arm is a great weapon by a running back. So now at the 45-yard line, it's going to be first down, and they'll spot it actually at the 46-yard line now. 3:51 to go. The Asheville Cougars leading in their playoff game. So good luck to Coach Wilkins and Asheville, along with T.C. Robertson. They're both in their respective 3A and Big 3A in state playoff activity. Cody White to the 47-yard line, a gain of about a yard on the play. On the stop as they all entangle there, and the bottom of the pile is going to be Matt Nixon, who plays left tackle on offense, defensive end on defense, 5'10", 220. So now second down at the 47, clock running, 3:15 and counting left to play in the second quarter here tonight. As we mentioned, great crowd. Elkin brought a good crowd down from Bucking Elk territory, as we mentioned, about 3.5 hours or so away. Mercer comes in motion back to the line. Scotty hands off. Little misdirection to the 49-yard line of Elkin. So staying on the ground, Cody White knocked down on the play by Donnie Bell.
Ball now marked on about the 49-yard line of the Elks.
Good athletic program at Elkin High School. As we mentioned last year, they won the state football championship, the state men's tennis championship, and the wrestling championship. That's a pretty darn good year to win three titles in any sport. So a quality athletic program at Elkin High School. Third down now. Our Maroon Devils need a, we'll call it a short four or a long three, if you will. Mercer in motion, got a penalty flag down. Cody White's in the secondary, but it may come back. Cody White may take it all the way to the house. He's going to be angled in, and he is run out of bounds, but it's not going to matter as the penalty flag is going to be against our Maroon Devils. So all that great run of about 50 yards and then some is going to be coming back. Well, that's not a good sign as we see Josh Anthony, one of our key players, limping off the field. And we hope he's going to be okay. What a great year by Josh, averaging 20 yards on each reception, and he's had 28 receptions. Boy, he's stumbling off. Good thing is he's under his own power. Let's hope he comes back because Josh has one pick tonight. We had motion against the Devils on offense. That's going to set us back and wipe out a gain of over 50 yards by Cody White, who already has over 120 yards rushing tonight. And we're not even at halftime. 2:08 to play. Now, don't forget to get your DVD or VHS tapes of the broadcast, only $15. And you can have it mailed to you, only $5. So Hometown Television has it all for you. Third down. We're going to call it almost nine, and we got a penalty flag down. Scotty McMahon pointed a finger like somebody on defense was doing something, but let's see what the officials say. Coach Rod White, what a great career. In 8 years, 70 wins, 31 losses, one tie. He is 19-5 in the playoffs over 6 years. Has won state championship, almost another one last year. Offside against Elkin, so Scotty was right. Somebody jumped on their side of the ball. And that's what really gets the motor running for our Maroon Devils. That loss 24-22 last year against Elkin almost assuredly cost us a state title.
Third and three now for the Maroon Devils.
And all year long, that's kind of been in the back of the mind of these Maroon Devil players, coaches, and fans. So now with 2:08 to go, third down. Going to spot it at the 47. We need three to get a first down here. Cody White, right side, has the first down at the 47 now. 42, check that, 42-yard line of Elkin. So we're beginning to move that football again now. Now we have just over 2 minutes to try to bang it into the end zone and take an even bigger lead into the locker room at halftime before a big Maroon Devil crowd. And we hope all this Maroon Devil crowd and then some will travel down to Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh Saturday if this score holds up. Of course, we have a long way to go before you can pull out the party hats. Devils line him up tight on the right side. Scotty back to throw. Straight drop. Timing pattern. Up in the air. It's kind of overthrown, and it's actually intercepted at the 10-yard line. Pass intended down there for Justin Evans, but it's going to be picked off on the play. And if we can see that number, it's going to be 26 on the interception. Will Stewart. So that pass, kind of a timing pattern. Both guys had a shot, and both guys were kind of turned around. And Will Stewart comes down with it for Elkin. But now their problem is they only have a minute 39 seconds to try to do something with it before halftime. And I know Scotty's unhappy with himself. Two interceptions all year, and he has two tonight in the first half. Two tough passes here that were picked off, but hey, the scoreboard is still 20-0, Scotty. Don't let that get you down. Hand off left side, Elkin, not a bad run out across the 20-yard line before a bunch of guys led by Jason Boston on defense on the tackle. Nothing new there. Jason's in on a lot of tackles on the season, 54 tackles. Leading our team in the tackle department, of course, Mitchell Green with 67, Craig Autry with 54.
Ball now marked on the 16.
Guys like Jason had 54, Eric Stevenson had 58, Cody White had 61 tackles. A lot of guys getting it done on defense. That's why we're giving up less than 10 points a game. Hand off to the left side, and looks like the Elks get a first down up there on the tackle. Looks like 51, Travis Brooks and company. And we're going to have a timeout, I believe, called by Elkin. Let's see. No, it's going to be called by Swain, actually, with 101 to go. That'll stop the clock, and we'll be back. Elkin gets the timeout.
From the Elkin. Got 20-0 with a minute left to go in the third. I mean, the second.
Okay, fans, here we go. Final minute of the first half coming at you. Elkin with the football. Rolling to the right is going to be Transone. Throwing on the run. He's got his man on the sideline. Chased out of bounds by Justin Evans, but a nice gain for the Elks as, again, they have their one-minute offense in gear, if you will. Stopping the clock, getting out of bounds with 55 and a half seconds to play. So the Elks coming in this state 1A semifinal. Defending State 1A champions. A lot of pride on the line tonight for them as well. Back to throw. Transone again. Rolling, throwing. Has his man. He's got it again at the 42-yard line. Nice completion. Two in a row. Stephen Mercer on the tackle as he hits his man down there, Ben Crosswhite. Now the chains will move, and once the chains are set, the clock will start again. Right now it's at 48.9 seconds to go in the half. And our defense has got to stop Elkin and keep them out of the end zone. Now they get the chain set at the 43 of Swain. And looks like we had a whistle before the play even got underway. But talking about Elkin and Swain, Swain, one of the largest 1A teams in the state with 543 students. Elkin with 357 students in the 1A division, so a difference of almost 200 students there. Our Maroon Devils are right on the verge of being kicked up into 1AA. And every year that can change with the average daily membership, they call it, the ADM, which is the number of students in the school. Back to throw. Transone has plenty of time. Throws back, and it's going to be caught down there by Hagen Miller. Another first down. Stops the clock with 38.2 seconds. They mark it at the 25. So Elkin with their best field position tonight in Maroon Devil territory here. But the clock a factor now. 38 seconds to play. Elkin looks like with one timeout left. And they're going to call it right here.
The Elks will have a first and 10.
To the timeout, the Elkin Bucking Elks trying to get on the scoreboard before halftime. Rolling again, it's going to be Transone, and he's brought down in a big sack. Coming in there on defense is number 61, Mitchell Green, one of the captains on this football team. Mitchell. Stopping the clock at 28 seconds to play. Elkin calls another timeout.
28.8.
Their last one. We have 28.8 seconds to play. And now they're at the 35-yard line. Got to keep them on the zero end of the scoreboard. Back to throw. Transone, and it's going to be, is it intercepted? It was close down at the 15. And no. Stephen Mercer was there. He might have picked it off the top of the ground. Boy, that was close. Good job down there as well. He already has one pick tonight. He almost got another one. 20 seconds now on the incomplete pass. Elkin now with a third down. They still need about 19 to go from the 35. They got to get down to the 15 for a first down. And again, they're out of timeouts. Swain fans on their feet here. Got to get the defense revved up. A three-man front now by the Maroon Devil defense. Got four men coming after the quarterback. And they're coming after him. He misses one guy. Throws down on the sideline. He's got a man. Only a short gain at the 24-yard line. Out of bounds, but it stops the clock. 11.4 seconds to play here. Pass complete to Wells Stewart. Just inside the marker down there, but it's going to bring up fourth down. So now two big problems for Elkin. They have a fourth down and 8 coming up, and the clock with only 11 and a half seconds to go before halftime. And not only that against them, but this outstanding defense giving up only 8.8 points a game. Those three factors are not a whole lot of fun, but they're going to try a field goal. They're going to spot it at the 32. It'll be a 42-yard field goal. On the kick is going to be Will Stewart. Wow, he's got it, but it's not even close. Not even close. It's wide, it's short, and it's very satisfactory for the Maroon Devil fans. We get the ball back with 6.5 seconds to play in the half, and probably will hit a knee and take it to the locker room. But an outstanding defensive effort by the Maroon Devils on that particular series, as Elkin was throwing the ball very well, trying to move the ball down the field. So now we can just hit a knee, as we mentioned, and go inside, get warmed up a little bit in the locker room, and get ready for the second half here tonight at Swain County Memorial Stadium in Boy Steets Field. And we hit a knee. That's going to wind it up. First half is in the books, and the Devils lead it 20-0 over Elkin. Go. Swain County High School, and another trip to the State 1A Championship Saturday in Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh, North Carolina, 12 noon. That's right, high noon, middle of the day kickoff down in North Carolina State Wolfpack territory. But Elkin, of course, has a lot to say about that as we have 24 more minutes to get the job done. Elkin will kick it back. We get to start on offense. Good kick. Going to be taken by, looks like, Cody White back at the 12. Out to the 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. Cody, penalty flag down. Cody's back at midfield and then some, but it might come back. Penalty flag is down. And normally, yeah, it's against the return team. It's a holding call. Just about every time you see a penalty flag on a return game, it's holding on the return team. Punts, kickoffs, you name it. And this one will come back, but what a great return by Cody White as he brought it well back across the 50-yard line. But now it's going to be backing up. Talking about Cody White, what a great first half. 15 carries, 144 yards. Folks, that's almost 10 yards a carry. 15 carries, 144 yards for the big guy who's having a great, great career at Swain County High School. Coming into the ballgame, Cody third on the all-time rushing yardage list with 3,137 yards. He needed 241 to pass Johnny Buck Mitchell, and tonight he's having a pretty good night doing that. Penalty flag down on the play, and that'll give me time to remind you that Hometown Television is going to be broadcasting middle school basketball on Hometown TV, as well as varsity double basketball coming soon on HTTV. So be sure and tune in for all the fun there. Don't forget about the Bryson City Christmas Parade. It's going to be broadcast right here on Hometown Television as well. Right now, first down, the Maroon Devils only need five. After Elkin backed up five with a penalty of their own, coming in motion is going to be Mercer. Coming back to the inside, Cody White getting a block out to the 43-yard line. Cody White, they'll spot it probably at the 42. And on the tackle is going to be Tyler Transeau, who plays quarterback on offense. Talking about that, the quarterback last year, number 10, Hagen Miller, is now a wide receiver and free safety. So a totally new backfield we're looking at this year for Elkin High School. Hagen Miller shaking up a little bit, the guy we were just talking about who played quarterback last year for Elkin. And he's shaking up, and the trainers come on to attend to him. He's walking off, so he looks okay from here, but we'll see if he'll be back. He plays both ways, as a lot of these kids on both teams do. A lot of these kids play both ways. So now just underway in the second half. Maroon Devils with 20 points on the board at halftime. Last year we had 22 and a heartbreaking loss to Elkin up at Elkin Country. Now we get the whistle blowing and we're ready to roll now. Scotty McMahon gets over center, two in the backfield behind him. Now he calls a timeout, saw something he didn't like, so we'll break as well with 11:29 to play in the third quarter. Okay, fans, after the timeout, the Devils now got set on offense. First down and 10. Now Scotty checking off at the line, looks like. Shouts out the signals to his backs right behind him. And the handoff to the left side, still penalty flags down. Cody hit the ground. Ball popped loose, but there is a penalty flag. It's going to be Elkin's ball, but let's see what the penalty is all about.
70 recovered.
So not exactly the way we wanted it. Penalty flag against the Devils. So the penalty is declined, obviously, by Elkin. And the Elks get it first down and 10. So we have had some turnovers in the ball game tonight in the first half. We were picked off twice on interceptions. And luckily for us, we didn't give away the one fumble when we
still got it.
Fumbled one time. Tossed to the right side. Now Elkin back with the football. They have a nice running lane on the right side. On the carry is going to be Chris Martin. On the tackle, Cody White. But not before a pickup of about 6 yards. Spotted at the 40. We'll call it second and four. 11:03 to play in the third quarter. But a great first half for the Maroon Devils. We had the edge almost double in possession time. 15 minutes we held the football in the first half to only 9 for Elkin. More on that in just a minute now as the Elks line them up in the eye. And this one only a couple of yards. On the carry is Kedron Bullock. Bullock going forward. And we have an injured Devil down. Looks like maybe Jason Boston. No, check that. 39 injured there. Eric Stevenson. He gets up, but he's shaken up a little bit.
39.
But Eric's a tough kid. Eric Stevenson, one of our leaders on defense. Looks like he might have to come out as they just want to be sure. Looks like he took a lick to the head, and that's something you don't take for granted. So he got a little dizzy on that play. So he comes out of the ball game, and Eric will be back. You can count on that. Third down now. The Elks need 3. They hand off to the right side, and he's not going to make it. In on the tackle. Looks like, is that Mitchell Green? And, yes, also on that help over there is Travis Brooks. So Travis Brooks on the initial hit, and it's going to bring fourth down now for Elkin. Down 20-0 with 10 minutes to play in the third quarter. I've got to think Elkin may go for it. I mean, this is the state semifinal playoff game. You're down 20-0. You haven't moved the ball very well all night. You got to gamble, and now Elkin is going to gamble. Fourth down, they need 3. If they get it, they keep this drive alive. They still haven't got any points on the scoreboard yet. They line them up, twins on the left side. Franco looking to the left side, has time. He throws. It's going to be picked off at the 40-yard line again. It's going to be Josh Anthony. Anthony, his second interception tonight and his 9th on the season. Again, the Maroon Devils getting it done with the interceptions here tonight. So Josh picking off some balls here this season, all season long. But talking about the first half, we had 187 yards rushing in the first half. Elkin had only 40. That is a huge stat in the first half, the ability to run the football. We've got it back at the 40. This happened last time Elkin got inside our territory. Hand off right side. Cody White carries to the 46-yard line. Nice gain of 6 on the play. And on the tackle is going to be 23, and that's Code Westra. So Westra in on the stop. Second down and 4 now for the Maroon Devils. Coming back in, Jason Boston with the play along with Scotty McMahon. As offensive coordinator, Steve Manley gets the play in with 9 minutes to play in the third quarter now. And again, each time the Elks have been inside our territory threatening, they turn the football over. Coming in motion is going to be Steven Mercer. Toss to Cody White, trying to get outside, and he busts inside. Cuts back and gets out to the 48-yard line. It's going to bring up third down and a couple. But again, what a great playoff run for the Maroon Devils, getting into the state semifinals once again. Swain has won 11 playoff games in a row here at Swain County Memorial Stadium. Last time we lost was to Graham, 13-10, back in the year 2000. Trying to make it 12 playoff games in a row here tonight. Third down and a couple. It's going to be Cody White, and he dives. It depends on the spot, and they're going to spot it short. He dove forward, but he is just a hair short at the 49-and-a-half-yard line. Now we've got fourth down, and, hey, we're going to go for it. I have a real good feeling. We need less than half a yard. Matter of fact, a foot would do it. And our fans are chanting, go, go, go. You know what's on their mind. And coming back in, it's going to be Jason Boston and Scotty McMahon, and we're going to go. Our Maroon Devils have a lot of confidence in the defense. And the defense has gotten it done all year. Handoff right side, Cody White with 5 yards and then some for the first down. At the 45-yard line of Elkin now. Those Devils keep on marching forward. 7:24 to play in the third quarter. And the Devil fans are still happy.
First and 10, Maroon Devils.
So it's getting ever so likely we could be playing in Raleigh this Saturday at 12 noon against probably Southside. They were shellacking Northside in their playoff game. So two teams that start with an S could be playing in a city that starts with an R Saturday at high noon. Raleigh, North Carolina, the site. Toss to Cody White, left side, breaks a tackle and carries to the 41-yard line. It's going to bring up second down and 5. 6:50 to play, and the clock is running. As we mentioned just a moment ago, the Maroon Devils have given up only one score this year. 7 points last week to Hopton. Everybody else has been held scoreless by the defense that just doesn't give up much all season long. As we said, 8 points a game. A lot of those points were given up by the JVs and other guys playing late. Penalty flag. Somebody moved in there for the Maroon Devil offensive line. So they'll back it up 5, and that's going to bring up second down at about 10 or so for the Maroon Devils on offense.
Illegal procedure, motion against the Maroon Devils. 5 yards.
But again, just an outstanding first half, controlling the football on the ground as we outrushed Elkin 187-40. And when you can do that in a high school football game or any other football game for that matter, you're controlling the line of scrimmage, and that's where the football game is normally won. Second down now, still 10, as we lost 5 on the penalty. Scotty McMahon putting Justin Evans in motion, and the handoff straight ahead. Cody White got a lot of it back after the penalty. They're going to spot the football this time. At the 40, we'll call it about the 42. Well, about the 43, actually. So that's going to bring up third down and still almost 8. 5:45, though, the Maroon Devils are killing the time on the clock. And as long as we roll the clock, Elkin's going to be rolling back home with a loss. The clock right now already beginning to play into this football game. Scotty got Evans in motion again, coming back toward the line. He tosses to the right side. Cody wants to throw, has pressure, up for grabs. It could be picked off, but nobody is there for anybody to try to catch that ball. Cody hits the ground, and he had no time to throw. Blitzing was Wesley Martin, the right side defensive back over there, and he had to get that ball away. So the halfback pass is thwarted by a big Elkin rush. Fourth down, we're going to have to punt this one now as Devin Smathers, another of the 19 seniors, playing a great ball game tonight. Back to return, it's going to be Hagen Miller, one of 4 seniors on this team. Nice hang time on the punt. Miller's going to call a fair catch at about the 14, and Elkin is going to have poor field position again here with 5:13 to play in this third quarter. Don't forget, tonight's playoff game is being professionally videotaped, just like the Bryson City Christmas Parade will be, and broadcast very soon here. Yeah. You got wireless mics, 3-chip cameras, and all the interviews with Coach White and many more. A portion of the proceeds from tape sales comes back to the Maroon Devils, so enjoy the game for years to come and support our team. Orders will be ready for pickup by next Friday, or for $5, have it mailed to you. Only $15 for DVD or VHS tape. And thank you to all the supporters. Right side, here comes Elkin on the ground again. Chris Martin carries. Nice run, and he has a first down out near the 25-yard line. Dragging him down over there was number 25, Stephen Mercer, on the initial hit for the defense. So 5:05. And again, the clock and enemy of Elkin. I think they're kind of outnumbered tonight. We have more fans, got a better defense, and the clock is in our favor right now, thanks to a 20-0 lead. Got the fence walkers there, and cheerleaders doing their thing. The band doing great job at halftime. Everything's clicking tonight. The handoff to the left side, and there on the tackle is Earl King, looks like. Big Earl putting a stop to him.
On the carry that time, number 33, Junior Hoosier.
And on the carry that time was a junior Hoosier, a senior. 4 seniors on the Elkin team. So they get almost everybody back next year. And that's not good news for the rest of the state. Elkin with a great football tradition down there. Two state championships in a row, last year and the year before. Second down now. The Elks need about seven. Misdirection handoff. The tailback's got it, and he doesn't have much. On the carry is going to be Chris Martin. Martin, the tailback, at the 31-yard line, runs into Jason Boston and company, and we have a whistle and injured Elk on the play. So he's still on the ground, and we have a brief timeout with 4:12. Injured on the play over there is going to be number 70, Matt Nixon, who plays left tackle on offense, defensive end on defense. 5'10", 220 junior. He walks off and seems to be okay. Most of the guys shaking up tonight have come back on to play, and that's a good sign. When you can play a whole football game and have no injuries on either side, it's a good night. But football is it's not a contact sport, fans. Football is a collision sport. And that's why injuries are part of the game. Back to throw, Transo pumps, now dumps it off to a swing man out there at the 30-yard line, knocked out of bounds at the 34. Good defense over there by Eric Stevenson. Also over there is a guy who was shaken up a few plays ago, Josh Anthony, in helping out on the tackle along with Eric Stevenson. So those guys are getting it done. Fourth down now. Elkin again struggling against this Maroon Devil defense, but hey, what else is new? Everybody struggles against this Swain County defense. Elkin's going to punt it away. 3:54 to go on the third. They're down 20-0. Back deep, we're going to have Josh Anthony. He is the deepest man back there. Also back with him looks like Stephen Mercer. Not a big rush. Nice punt. Mercer, fair catch, and has it at the 41-yard line. Great field position as the Devils get it back, and time running down on Elkin as the Devils lead it 20-0 with 3:46 to play in the third quarter. But
3:46 is the time.
So the ball is spotted on the Swain 41-yard line.
And away we go, fans. First down and 10 now. The split backs behind Scotty McMahon, and the big guy, Shuler, gets it out to the 42-yard line. And on the tackle over there for the Elks, Terry Adams, 6'2", 230-pound junior. The Elks have a lot of guys with some big size up front. And again, a team to look for in the future as Elkin, the number 3 seed in the West Division, have a 13-playoff game winning streak. Last time they lost in the playoffs, it was to Rosman, November 23rd, 2001. But that streak in big danger here tonight at Swain County High School. Again, it's going to be a hard run to the left side, 46-yard line, and it looks like somebody lost a shoe. So was that, I think that's Cody White's shoe, and no flag on the play, so a good gainer. And he may have to come out while somebody, well, he's going to try to get the shoe back on. And boy, Cody White runs pretty good with shoes or out shoes. He had 144 yards in the first half on 15 carries. That's almost 10 yards a pop. So checking into the ball game, Justin Evans now, as we have 2:50 to play in the third quarter. And we'll take a break here. All right, fans, Cody White has his shoes back on, and we're ready to go. He's had a great night tonight. Third down now. Scotty McMahon running the option. Almost ran into one of his own guys, and he cuts back inside. And Scotty takes it all the way to the first down line at the 43-yard line. Move the chains. Chain gang, 2:23 to go, and the Devils running out that clock with a 20-0 lead late here in the third quarter. And the Devil fans are loving it after last year's tough loss, 24-22 at Elkin, and the freezing rain and snow and wind. And Elkin had a great football team last year that won their second state championship in a row. Wide to the right side, we've got a couple. Justin Evans over there along with Josh Anthony. And Scotty McMahon not happy with what he sees. So the Devils take a timeout with 2 minutes to play in the third quarter. It's been all Swain County tonight, leading Elkin 20-0 now. Scotty is in the shotgun for the first time tonight. He throws over the middle, and it's almost picked off, thrown a little high over the outstretched hands of number 10, Hagen Miller. But he gunned it over the middle. That'll stop the clock now with 1:54 to play on the third. But again, interesting set there as Scotty was in the shotgun. We haven't seen a whole lot of that this year. But Scott, he's pretty happy and pretty comfortable in about any set. And offensive coordinator Steve Manley gets the job done every week, week in and week out. Checking in, Jason Boston now with the play. But the winner of this game will play at 12 noon Saturday in Raleigh, North Carolina, against probably Southside High School, who is really winning easily against Northside in their playoff game. Scotty's in trouble. He's going to take the sack. Good decision. He really didn't have time to throw, and so he eats the football. So that's going to cost us back to the 48-yard line now, and that's going to bring up a third down and 15 with a minute 37 to play. So a lot of pressure coming in. Matt Nixon, among others, on the sack for Elkin High School. So now the Devils have about 15 yards to go for a first. Checking in is Craig Autry over there. Splitting wide to the right side is going to be Justin Evans. Autry's going to line up tied on the left side. Devils in the eye. Scotty's going to throw. He's got a blitz coming from the right. He gets away from that, throws it on the run, and it's short. Evans can't get to it, and we're going to punt it away. We haven't punted very much tonight, and that's a good sign. Just a little more than a minute to go in the third quarter here. And the Maroon Devils will return for a state 1A championship bid Saturday at Carter-Finley Stadium. Lots of seats there, folks, so don't worry about having enough seats. Down in Raleigh, home of the Wolfpack. High snap. Elkin, pretty good rush. End-over-end punt. And it's going to be taken at the 23. Back to the 25. A little shake and bake over there by Miller. And he's knocked down at the 27-yard line. Good coverage down there along with Isaac Crisp, among others, on the tackle for the punt team. Under a minute to play. Elkin gets it back here. And let's see what they can do with it. So far tonight, Elkin not really productive on offense. Now let's see if they can change that here as time runs out on them. They have about 13 minutes left in this game to make something happen. But remember, last year's game went down to the wire 24-22 before the Maroon Devils lost a heartbreaker. But last year, Elkin controlled the football on the ground. This year, our Maroon Devils are controlling the football on the ground. Handoff straight ahead to the 32-yard line as Elkin. On the carry is going to be Chris Martin again. On the stop, Travis Brooks for the Devil defense. Also Dusty Lossie and Jason Boston. Those guys are always around the football. Clock running. Elkin has three timeouts. The Maroon Devils have one. But right now, the Maroon Devils don't want a timeout. They want the clock to roll as much as it will. Checking out of the lineup for Elkin. Alex Lopez, 5'9", 225, senior. Only four seniors on this Elkin team. This is not the team we saw last year, as you can tell by the 20-0 score. Back to throw, Transo, right side, has his man. He's got a first down. He curls back, and he's going to be stopped at the 41-yard line. Jason Boston over there putting the hands on him. 8.5 seconds to play in the third quarter. They'll move the chains, and Elkin might get one more play in here before the Now the clock is running. They're not even going to get that. So that's the end of three as the Devils are dominating tonight in the state semifinals, 20-0 over Elkin. One more quarter coming up. So second down coming up now for Elkin. And the fourth quarter. And right now, as we mentioned earlier, Elkin has a lot of enemies. The Swain defense, the Swain fans, and the clock. As time is beginning to stack up against the Elks. Transo back to throw. Down the middle, he guns it, and he has his man, and he's got it. No, he dropped it. Oh, he had it momentarily. There was triple coverage down there, actually. Justin Evans was down there. Looks like Stephen Mercer was there. Also down there was Josh Anthony. But it was almost complete down there to the big guy, Will Stewart, who is 6'2". He's a pretty good target down there with 11:14 to play. But Elkin has got to pull out the stops here. They can't run the football now, down by three touchdowns with only 11:14 to go. They've got to pull out the stops and throw on a whole lot of plays here in the last quarter of play here. But what a great night for these 19 seniors. Transo back again. He's got his man. This time it's knocked loose. This should be a fumble. This has got to be a fumble. It was caught and it was knocked loose.
Pass is ruled incomplete.
I can't believe the officials ruled that incomplete. That ball was caught at the 42, and the reason being it was caught because it was knocked so far back down the field. I can't believe the officials ruled that incomplete. That ball was caught at the 42, and the reason being it was caught because it was knocked so far back down the field. I just can't believe that was ruled incomplete. But wow, somebody put a helmet on that football as it went flying. But anyway, if I sound like a homer, it's because I am. Fourth down, and a timeout called. Elkin with 11:04 to play. We'll be back after this. Okay, fans, fourth down. Elkin's going to punt it away, even though they only have 11 more minutes to play with a football. Low snap. They dig it up. Not a big rush, though. High, high punt, and a fair catch and a good job at the 37-yard line down there by Stephen Mercer. So the Devils get it back here, and Elkin can feel this football game getting out of their grasp here, down 20-0. And obviously they need three touchdowns to have any kind of a prayer in this ball game, because even two touchdowns, two extra points, and a field goal wouldn't do it. So they got to have three touchdowns to get back into this one. And the clock is a problem, and so are the Maroon Devils here, pitching a shutout against the defending State 1A champion Elkin. We might see a whole lot of running here in the fourth quarter. Scotty tosses Cody White out across the 40, out to the 45-yard line. Cody White, just a moment ago, we were adding it up, and Cody only needed about 62 yards to pass Johnny Buck Mitchell on the all-time rushing list. Rocky Dietz, he's pretty safe out there with over 4,000. But Johnny Buck Mitchell is in danger, because if Cody White doesn't pass him tonight, he may get Johnny Buck this coming Saturday in Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh. Right now, Elkin with five men up front and your basic 52 defense. It's going to be Casey Shuler to the 49. That looks good enough for a first down from here before he's tackled on the play by Keith Whitman. Let's see if the chains are going to move. They should. Yes, they do. First down, Maroon Devils. That'll move the chains. And the clock keeps running in our favor, and that's the way we like it. As KC and the Sunshine Band would say. Yes, indeed. Well, that brings up some memories from the past. Let's break out the disco. Yes, yes, the days of Afro. First down and 10. Got a man in the backfield behind Scotty McMahon. He's going to run the option, and he's going to keep it. He cuts back, and he has nowhere to go. Might have lost a play at the 49-yard line. Even that's okay right now with 9:44 to play. Stay between the sidelines. Keep running the football. The clock doesn't stop. And Elkin can't do anything about it right now. But, again, as we keep hearing in the press box, south side, who is the number one seed in the East Division, is just rolling over north side in their state semifinal playoff game. So south side is going to be a huge opponent in the state championship game, without a doubt. Toss to the left side. It's going to be Cody White. He's trying to find a hole. It doesn't get one. Got back to the line of scrimmage, and it's going to bring up third down at about 9, right on the 50-yard line. 9 minutes, speaking of 9, left to play here, as the Devils can almost taste it. Almost taste it. Last year, 24-22. This year, 20-0. Going to be a lot of celebrating by these seniors who were down there in that nasty weather last year in Elkin. Down on the riverbanks. Had a long, cold ride home. But tonight, it's Mountain football. Scotty McMahon locks back. He's got the screen, and it's going to be picked off at the 40. Coming back with the screen is going to be Matt Nixon. Nixon is going to bring this one all the way home. And Elkin gets on the scoreboard on a freak play here in the fourth quarter. A screen play set up to Cody White. Nixon intercepted it. The big lineman, 5'10", 220, brought it back for the touchdown with 8:19 to play. So Elkin gets on the board. Only the second touchdown given up by the Maroon Devils here in the state 1A playoffs this year. So Elkin will line up for the point after touchdown. And kind of stunned at the crowd, if you will. That was the last guy we expected to score a touchdown as a big defensive end, Matt Nixon, who intercepts it and runs it all the way back after the play here. Now we have a penalty flag down. So let's see what this is about. And looks like we may have an illegal substitution maybe. Or so coming off the field right now is going to be Big Earl King. Well, just to be honest, we had too many guys. They won't let you play with 12. Point after touchdown now by Elkin. And this is good, so Elkin gets on the board with 8:19 to play, but it's Maroon Devils 20, Elkin 7. We'll be back. All right, fans, Elkin getting a kind of a slight sliver of hope after that touchdown return on the interception. Now the Maroon Devils bring it back at the 20-yard line, back out to the 20, and slipping is going to be Steven Mercer. We get the ball back with a little more than 8 minutes to play, 8 and change here on the fourth quarter, leading 20-7. We've got to keep playing, though. You don't want anything crazy to happen here. Elkin scores again, then things get really interesting. So the Maroon Devils just need a good time-consuming run the football, stay in bounds kind of drive here. That could really seal this one up. This series is really big for the offense. Don't want to give it back to Elkin yet. And the handoff goes to the left side. Not much room there. Elkin, again, getting a little breath of life here late in the ball game with 8 minutes to play. But 8 minutes is a long time. At the 30-yard line, it's going to bring up second down at 8 now for the offense. Coming in, Jason Boston with Scotty McMahon in the play from Steve Manley on the sideline. Again, our coaching staff doing a great job. Rod White, 70-31-1 in 8 years, 19-5 in the playoffs over 6 seasons. Scotty tosses. Cody White runs into a stack of guys and doesn't get much. Matter of fact, we lost a yard. So that's going to bring up a third down now, and we're going to need close to 10 yards. They spot it at the 29. We'll call it 39. 7:23 to play. The clock is still running. But a first down now would be really nice. Coming in with the play this time from the sideline is number 85, Craig Autry. Autry trying to get the play in, and the Devils right now with 7:06 to go here in the playoff contest with Elkin. And the Maroon Devils in the lead 20-7 as the toss goes back to the right side. It's going to be Cody White, and he's knocked down for no gain again. Now we've got to punt it. And Elkin feeling a little frisky all of a sudden with 7 minutes to play. The door is not shut yet here in the state semifinal playoff game. Dropping back is going to be Hagen Miller. Miller back near midfield to return. We need a good punt right here. Elkin, known for blocking punts. They blocked two against us last year that just crushed us in that playoff game at Elkin. They had two blocked punts in that ball game last year. One led to a field goal. Another was recovered in the end zone for a touchdown. So I'm sure Coach Rod White and coaches remember the blocked punt ability of Elkin High School. We're going to move back five. After the penalty flag, now the line of scrimmage at the 24, so Elkin's going to get this football back, all things considered, in great field position here. And let's see if Elkin comes after this one. They have 8 guys up on the line. Pretty good rush. Good punt by Smathers. Line drive is going to hit. It's going to be picked up at the 42-yard line. On the return, it's going to be Martin at the 45-50. Martin is forced out of bounds over there. Good open field tackle by Casey Schuler for the punt return team, for the punt team. 6:08 to go now. Elkin with the football, and their fans are getting back into the ball game because they realize if they can score a touchdown here, then it's a one-touchdown ball game, and this thing's really crazy. So don't make your hotel reservations for Raleigh yet. First down and 10, Elkin at the 49. The defense has been tough tonight, though. Let's see if we can hold them. The only points Elkin has were actually given up by our offense. And off to the left side, it's going to be the quarterback, Transeau, carries down to near the 41-yard line. Nice gain of about 8, almost 9 yards on the play. Jason Boston on the tackle. Also with Eric Stevenson. Stevenson and Boston combined for the hit. 41-yard line, second down. One. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to another great Maroon Devil football showdown. And tonight it could be the showdown of the year as our Maroon Devils are hosting the Elkin Bucking Elks here tonight at Swain County Memorial Stadium and Boyce Dietz Field in a game that's kind of a heavyweight rematch, if you will, in the 1A football standings across the state of North Carolina. As all Maroon Devil fans know, last year at Elkin, the Elks won a heartbreaker, 24-22 for Maroon Devil fans. After that game, Elkin cruised to a state 1A championship. And we feel tonight another 1A state championship is going to be coming up after this one, as both these teams have rich football traditions and a lot is on the line tonight. But the Maroon Devils have that revenge on their mind after losing a tight 2-point ball game last season in the cold rain at Elkin. Tonight it's clear and cold at Swain County, and Zimmerman kicks it high. He kicks it deep. It's going to be taken actually at the 1-yard line, and Elkin is going to bring it out past the 10, and they're going to be stopped at the 14-yard line. And that's what Nick Zimmerman has been doing all season long, kicking it deep, not allowing much on the return game. As a matter of fact, Nick's kickoffs, 62% of them this year have been in the end zone. Many more inside the one before they're brought out, and Elkin is going to be dealing with that weapon all night long. Glad to be back again for more Maroon Devil football here on Hometown Television. And we are ready to rock and roll here tonight as the Devils will be on defense first. We won the toss and deferred to the second half as Elkin comes out running the football on the first play. They might have picked up 1 yard on the play as the Devil defense really, really converged. Jason Boston also on the tackle, Eric Stevenson. Eric and Jason, two of the leaders on this defense. Eric coming in with 58 tackles on the year. Jason with 54 tackles on the year, doing a good job inside. It's going to be second down now, and still almost 10 to go for the Elks here early in the first quarter. Again, weather conditions perfect for what we like to call mountain football, cold and clear. And we can see the middle of the field is still a little bit on the damp side, if you will, kind of worn in certain spots of the field here tonight. And out to the left side. Great run over on the left side out to the 22-yard line as the Maroon Devils, Jason Boston and company, provide the hit. One guy really got stuck. Justin Evans really got a hit by the Elkin running back on that particular play. It's going to bring up third down now and 3 for Elkin. 10:51 to go. We're in the first quarter now from Swain County Memorial Stadium. The winner of this game will play in Raleigh's Carter-Finley Stadium next Saturday, or this Saturday as you listen to this game on delayed broadcast. Left side, nowhere to go for Elkin, and it's going to bring up a fourth down for the Elks now. Good surge in the middle by the Maroon Devil defense, especially over there by number 34, Jason Boston, as he stopped Chris Martin, the tailback, on the play. So it's 34, knocking down 34, as now Elkin will have to punt. And back deep, a very dangerous duo for the Maroon Devils. Back deep, we're going to be having some guys who can bring it back. One of those is going to be Stephen Mercer. Over on the other side, it's going to be Josh Anthony. Nice punt by Elkin. Anthony at the 39 gets a block and brings it back out to the 44-yard line, where the Devils will take over first and 10 with 9:57 to play here in the first quarter. Up County have reporters from Swain County Radio, from Elkin Radio, from the Asheville Citizen tonight. We're glad to have Jacob Messer here on the press box with us. Asheville Citizen has provided some excellent newspaper coverage of Swain County football in the past couple of weeks, and the folks here in Swain County have really enjoyed it. Scotty McMahon to throw on first down, and he is in trouble and is going to be sacked on the play. And that hasn't happened very much in the entire playoff series this year. Scotty is going to be dropped, spotting the football at just shy of the 37-yard line. So Elkin putting heat on Scotty McMahon on the first play. Scotty very instrumental in that game last year at Elkin, as he had a very solid football game, along with Cody White, Justin Evans, and many more players. All the juniors, 19 of them, who were seniors now, remember the Elkin game very well tonight from last year. Scotty hands off right side. Maroon Devils stay on the ground. This is going to be Cody White. And what a year Cody White has had, as he's going to be knocked down over there on the play. But Cody White brought down by Keith Whitman, a 5'11 sophomore, very young Elkin team. That's the major difference in the team that was dominated by seniors last year. It's the exact opposite. Tonight, the Maroon Devils dominated with 19 seniors. On the flip side, Elkin only 4 seniors on this team that is very young, but they're very good, coming in 11-3 as the number 3 seed here in the Western Division. Third down now. McMahon rolling, looking, throwing on the run. It's going to be caught, and it's going to be short of the first down, though, at the 47-yard line. Just a yard short on a nice catch on the comeback by Josh Anthony. And I would think without a doubt our Maroon Devils are going to go for it on fourth down and a yard. So not something the Devils have really had a problem with this year. Justin Evans going back in. And down on the sideline, Devin Smathers trying to crank up the crowd as offensive coordinator Steve Manley calls the play. Going in is going to be Scotty McMahon. He wants to come back and make sure. And these guys are going to have to, well, they have plenty of time. Still over 15 seconds on the play clock here. So no reason to be in any hurry. Take your time. Get the call right. Get the play right. Fourth down and a yard at the Elkin 47-yard line. Two backs behind Scotty McMahon now as he tosses to the left side. Cody has the first down and then some. Breaks into the secondary. Look out. Down the sideline. Cody White all the way in. Maroon Devil touchdown. That one coming from about 47 yards away. 47 yards unofficially by Cody White. And that is kind of a play that erases some bitter memories from last year at Elkin High School. So the Devils jump on top first with 7:38 to play in the first quarter, 6-0. Nick Zimmerman, who has been deadly from anywhere on the field. Last week we saw a 44-yard field goal by Nick, and he has the potential to do a lot of things kicking the football. This one is going to be up, and it's going to be good. What else is new for Nick Zimmerman? So with 7:38 to play in the first quarter, the Devils strike first, 7-0 over Elkin.
Number 1, Wesley Martin. Number 34, Chris Martin. And number 62, Terry Adams. The deep backs receive Zimmerman sending kickoff.
Welcome back as the Devils get set to kick it back to Elkin. We stopped them the first time, we scored, and now Nick Zimmerman back in action, and another booming kick into the back of the end zone as the Maroon Devils again put Elkin at the 20-yard line, 80 yards away from pay dirt. And as Rod White said in an interview earlier this week in the Asheville newspaper, he said, anytime you put a team at the 20 and make them drive 80 yards, it's definitely a disadvantage for the offense. And that gives this Maroon Devil defense, which has been so impressive all year, a leg up. Our Devil defense giving up only 8.8 points per game while scoring 45.6 on the offensive side of the sticks. First down now. A touchback at the 20 as Elkin takes over in the I formation. They hand off to the left side. Jason Boston on the tackle. Boston comes storming in. Knocks number 34 down again. That's 34 again. Chris Martin, a 5'10 junior, weighs only 160 pounds. So Boston has about 40 pounds on him from the size advantage. And Boston just knocked him down for no gain. And that's going to bring up second and 10 now with 7:15 to play here in the first quarter. We'll talk more about the differences in these two teams here as the first quarter goes on. But again, Elkin, not the team that beat us last year. We'll see if that proves true on the scoreboard. Toss to the right side now. Trying to turn the corner. It's going to be number 34 again. Again, that's Chris Martin, and he's knocked down for only a short gain. Good tackle over there by Cody White. Also over there is going to be Justin Evans. Also on the stop is Eric Stevenson. This defense, again, playing tough football here tonight. But talking about Elkin, they're missing some of their big guns from last year. Justin Billups, who had over 3,000 yards, gone. Patrick Humphreys, the number two back, gone. Their top two receivers from last year, gone. Their quarterback from last year is now a wide receiver. So a much different offense Elkin throws at us here tonight. Their quarterback rolls to the left side. Right-hander throws down the field, and he overshoots his man who had a little room down there. Ben Crosswhite had a little opening down there, but the quarterback threw it too close to the sideline. It's going to be incomplete, bringing up third down and nine now for the Bucking Elks of Elkin High School. And that's easy for me to say. So right now, fourth down and nine. Elkin is going to have to punt it back for the Maroon Devil offense. Keith Whitman, who's a linebacker on defense, is coming on to punt. He's only a sophomore.
Number 24,
and again, back deep for the Maroon Devils, we have, looks like, Stephen Mercer. Along with him, Josh Anthony, who's truly a big play guy on offense and defense. Anthony with seven interceptions this year on defense. Kind of an end-over-end punt, not the best of the year by Elkin, and a penalty flag is down. It goes out of bounds near the 45-yard line, but a penalty flag is down, the first flag of the night. Last week, if the Maroon Devils had anything at all that was in the negative column, it was penalties. We were charged with 82 yards in penalties. This penalty is illegal procedure against Elkin. Obviously, it's going to be declined by the Maroon Devils, and we get the football in great field position at the 45-yard line with 6:08 to play here in the first quarter. As Coach Rod White said last week, one of our main goals is to establish our will against Elkin. And so far, the Maroon Devils are doing that against the Bucking Elks here in the first quarter. First down, great field position at the 45-yard line of Elkin territory. Scotty and company setting up the offense. We might have had a guy move on the offensive line. No flag is down, though, and it's going to be trouble for the running game. Elkin strung that one out really well as Casey Shuler had nowhere to go, and Elkin played sideline to sideline. Good technique football. But Elkin, great year on the last couple of years. They've won the last two state 1A championships in 2002 and 2003. Their men's tennis team won the state championship in 2003. And their wrestling team won the state championship in 2003. So the Elkin teams were blessed with great athletes the past couple of years. Let's hope it's Swain County's turn this year. Second down and 10. And this time it's going to be a great hole again, as all the way down inside the 30 is going to be Cody White. Cody White, as we mentioned, came in with a special vengeance against Elkin. As you know, Cody had a big fumble in that ball game last year. And a lot of folks said, hey, that was a big play in the game. It was. But there were so many big plays in that ball game last year at Elkin. We'll talk more about those as the game progresses. That's a big first down for Cody, who already has one touchdown run tonight. And that's the difference on the scoreboard. 7-0 with 5.5 minutes to play in the first quarter here. Elkin right now with a bunch of guys in the box. Eight men up there tied against the Maroon Devil offense. Toss to the left side. It's going to be Cody White again. He's got some room again at the 20. Down to the 15. Inside the 15, Cody White with another Maroon Devil first down. Cody, a great year running the football this year. 166 carries, 1,294 yards. Averages a whopping 7.8 yards a carry and has scored 25 touchdowns on the ground. So Cody White in a great year and plays pretty good defense, too. 61 tackles, leads the team in tackles for losses with 13. So Cody White playing for his dad and doing a great job his senior season. He wants to win tonight probably more than anybody. Handoff straight ahead. It's going to be Casey Shuler and Big Casey bulls his way inside the 10-yard line to near the 8. It's going to bring up second down and about 4. And when we say big, Casey Shuler is a large lad at 5'11", 236, and he's only a junior. So he'll be one of the keys in the Maroon Devil football picture next year. We have 19 seniors, 10 juniors. So the juniors move up to lead the team next year, but this year, one of the greatest senior classes we have ever had in Swain County football history. Our tight end lines up on the right side. Strong right. The toss goes to the right side. Casey cuts back. Good tackle over there. Guy grabbed him by the leg at the 11 and drags him down as he got back to the line of scrimmage. It's going to bring up a third down, and we'll call it about 5. Third down and almost 5. Talking about Elkin. They're giving up 14.9 points a game. Their defense pretty stingy this year. They're averaging a little over 28 points a game offensively. And let's see if the Maroon Devils can dethrone the Elks here tonight. They've won the last two state championships in a row. Scotty McMahon over center now on third down. Got a man in motion, Justin Evans. Handoff goes to Cody White inside the 5. It's another first down. Cody White keeps moving the chains, and the chain gang on the sideline is happy to see that. Kind of chilly down there as well on the sideline. On the tackle over there is Tyler Trunceau and company on the stop for Elkin.
First and goal, Maroon.
3:36 to go, first quarter. The Devils lead it 7-0, on the verge of adding more on the scoreboard here. 4 downs to go, 4 yards. And with the averages of people like Cody White and Casey Shuler and Eric Stevenson, doesn't take many plays to pop it in there. Let's see what happens. Cody gets the call. Right side. He is in. Touchdown. But hold the phone. A flag is down. And normally when it's in that territory, it's probably a holding call on the offense. And let's see if that's the case. That can really sting. That's going to bring up a 1st and 9. So instead of 1st and goal at the 4, it's, or instead of the touchdown that Cody White just scored, we're going to move back to the 9. And call it 1st down again. But again, talking about the Elks last year, a couple of block punts were big in the first half as Elkin's Adam Weatherman blocked a Swain punt, giving Elkin the ball on Swain's 21-yard line. From there, they kicked a 25-yard field goal. And then a second block punt in the first half. Terry Adams crashed through and blocked a punt. And that was recovered in the end zone to give Elkin a 16-0 lead. Two special teams block punts were huge in that game last year. Tight end, tied on the left side now, 1st down.
He still got it.
Scotty, you know, he hands off up the middle and getting some tough yards, knocked down at the 7-yard line, is going to be Cody White. Also on the tackle is going to be Keith Whitman. Keith Whitman, a busy, busy guy on offense, or on defense, rather. Keith Whitman, the linebacker. So just inside the 7-yard line. It's going to bring up 2nd and goal there with 3:19 to play. Coming in with the play is going to be Jason Boston, who plays defense and also lines up some on the tight end spot on offense. He lines up tight on the right side now, as now the Maroon Devils go with a power set. Handoff left side. It's going to be Stevenson. Is he in? Yes. Eric Stevenson bangs it into the end zone. That's the first time we've seen that offensive set tonight for the Maroon Devils, and it paid off. So offensive coordinator Steve Manley with a good call, and the Devils lead 13-0 with 3:17 to play in this first quarter. Zimmerman on to kick the extra point after touchdown. And number one is good. There's a good number for him because he's had a lot of number ones this year. He's now 116 out of 123 in his career. And the extra point is going to be good again for Nick Zimmerman, hitting over 94% of those. 14-0, Devils lead over Elkin. We'll be back. Welcome back, fans, here on Hometown Television. Tonight's playoff game being professionally videotaped using professional 3-chip cameras, wireless microphones, and play-by-play by the only guy they could find. So, hey, we're off and running as Zimmerman kicks this one high and very short and out of bounds. not his best kick of the year. So the Elkin Bucking Elks might have their best field position of the night. And don't forget now, a lot of pregame interviews that make this football broadcast a lot of fun. A portion of the proceeds from tape sales comes back to the Maroon Devils. So enjoy the game for years to come and support our team. Orders will be ready for pickup by Friday, or for $5, you can have it mailed to you. And because of the support of area businesses, cost for DVD or VHS tape is only $15. And thanks to all the Devil TV broadcast boosters. So contact Tammy Mincy, 497-6435. Kent or Cheryl Maxey at 488-1155. And also be watching here on Hometown Television for the Bryson City Christmas Parade broadcast. That is coming up this week as well. First down and 10, Elks at the 35. Their best field position on a kickoff tonight. They're looking for the big one. Throwing it down the field. It's going to be possibly picked off. Great defense down there by Justin Evans. Also on the defense is going to be Josh Anthony. They knock it down, but a tall wide receiver down there tried to pull it in, and he couldn't. As well, Stewart, 6'2", junior, had the size but couldn't pull it in. And that's one thing about our pass defense. It gets the job done. Talking about Josh Anthony, he has 7 interceptions this year, and I think he had number 8 in his mind on that particular play. 3:09 to go, first quarter. Devils up 14-0, but don't get too happy yet. More about that in just a moment. The quarterback is in trouble as the defense got to him. Dusty Lossie, Earl King on the sack as the quarterback feels the teeth of the Devil defense. Tyler Transu not giving any time. But talking about being up in a lead as the Devils are up 14-0, if you think back to last year, and we'll talk about that a lot tonight, Elkin got on top 16-0 in that ball game. And as you remember, the Maroon Devils stormed back to make it a 24-22 game. So a 16-0 lead maybe doesn't mean as much as you think if we go back and reflect on last year's game at Elkin. Quarterback back to throw again, rolling to the left side. Has time, now throws. It's up for grabs, and it's going to be knocked away. Good defense. And that's number 34, Jason Boston. Boston, good defense because the pass was close. The quarterback running to his left, throwing down that sideline. A tough pass anyway. And Jason with the defense, forcing Elkin to punt again. So Elkin not threatening yet to get on the scoreboard here in the first quarter. 2:25 to play, but both teams mixing it up. A lot of run, a lot of pass. But the defensive edge goes to Swain County here in the first quarter. 14-0 now. Low snap, but he gets it. And it's going to be another sideline-type punt. It's going to be brought back this time on the run by Stephen Mercer. Mercer back to the 45-yard line and cracked down right there. Good tackle over there by number 21, Levi Carter. Carter on the stop, and that's going to bring up first down again. And great field position, almost the same place we got the football last time, just inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. But again, talking about the great career of Nick Zimmerman, 117 out of 124 in his career in extra points, a little over 94%. And he has great academics on his mind, especially the Air Force Academy. So good luck to Nick in the next step. Scotty McMahon, quarterback keeper, down to the 42, got a couple of yards. But Scotty has run the ball very well this year. He's passed it well, but running the football, he's had a great year. 82 carries, 396 yards on the ground, and he has scored 8 touchdowns rushing. And that's maybe the difference this year. Scotty McMahon has matured tremendously as a quarterback. Last year, he did a great job in the Elkin game, but this year he has performed just flawlessly. For example, in the passing department, Scotty has passed 123 times this year on only 2 interceptions. That's a stat anybody at any level would love to have. Got a man in motion. Scotty, he's going to run the option to the right side. He's going to keep it. He is going to be very close to a first down at the 34-yard line. So talking about the running and the decision-making of Scotty, that's probably the big improvement. Running the option and the veer that Coach Rod White and Coach Manley like to run on offense, you've got to have a good decision-maker. And Scotty has been extremely talented in that department this year. They're going to call it third down and less than a yard now with a minute to play in the first quarter. Devils up 14-0. But with a team like Elkin, when you've got them down, you want to keep them down. As Coach White says, we got to keep establishing our will. on the other guys. Man in motion again. This time handoff to the left side. Cody with a first down and then some to the 31-yard line. So Cody White adding to his rushing total. As you know, the winner of this game moves on to the State 1A Championship game at Carter-Finley Stadium this Saturday coming up at high noon. They will play the winner of the South Side-North Side game. In the first quarter in that game, South Side looks to be a big favorite. They lead North Side 12-0. South Side ranked number one in the Massey Power Poll in the state. They have a tremendous football team. First down and 10. Just shy of the 30. Scotty to throw. Timing pattern left side, and it's going to be out of bounds. The chain crew, the chain walkers, fence walkers was what I'm trying to say. The fence walkers almost pulling that one down and almost got the cameraman on the sideline down there. So, again, a lot of great media coverage here tonight. The biggest press box crew we've had all season long. And it's great to have the coverage, and that's what happens when you have a great season, like our Devils, who are coming in 12-0 and the number one seed in the Western Division. A great, great season. But also good luck tonight to Asheville and T.C. Robertson, respectively. They are playing some great schools in their playoff game tonight as well. Second and 10 now after the incomplete pass. Scotty turns, fakes the handoff. He's in trouble, got pressure, he rolls, he throws, and it's going to be picked off at the 27-yard line. Back to the midfield stripe. Elkin, good job on defense. Picking it off is going to be Tyler Transo. And Transo brings it back. Scotty saw his man, but he was well covered. So that one forced in there a little bit, and Elkin makes us pay, bringing it back to the 48-yard line. So from the 48-yard line, 12 and a half seconds to play in the first quarter. Time for one, maybe two more plays. But the Devils again, feeling the turnover sting. The Elks having a tough time now, trying to get anything going on offense. They line him up with two wide to the right side. The quarterback looking to the right side, throws, timing pattern, right side, has a man, and it's picked off. Here comes Mercer. Stephen Mercer on the pickoff back to the 49-yard line. So Stephen Mercer with a big play on defense. And our defensive secondary has been there all year long. Jason Boston, three picks. Also, Josh Anthony with seven picks. And the first pick tonight. Now, 3 seconds to play in the first quarter. Let's see if they start the clock. And if they do, we probably won't run a play. So now, a big play. Two back-to-back interceptions. Elkin caught one. We got it right back. Two interceptions in a row. So now they're going to wait till the ball snaps to start the clock. We'll get one play in before the end of period number one. Tight end strong on the right side. Mercer comes in motion after a big interception. A little misdirection and the handoff to Stevenson, but not much room to go as the first quarter comes to an end. The Devils lead Elkin 14-0. Lead 14-0 after one. If we continue this, the scoreboard's going to be nice at the end of the ball game. But hey, this is Elkin. Nothing is taken for granted now. The Devils have the football back. Moment ago, back-to-back interceptions. Elkin got one. We got it right back on the next play. Toss to Cody White, and he's going to be stopped for a loss on the play. Back at the 47-yard line. Cody White, just a moment ago, had six carries for 93 yards. Might have lost a yard there, but Cody White is definitely headed for a 100-yard-plus rushing night tonight. Elkin giving up some points this year, 14.9 on defense, but they don't break. They score 28.3 on the offensive side of the football. Talking about Cody White after one, seven carries, 98 yards, averaging 14 yards a pop. That's a great first quarter. So he's going to be over 100 very soon. Scotty back to throw. He's hit from behind. He's got his man down the right sideline. Justin Evans forced out of bounds over there. Good defensive play by Hagan Miller. Miller forced him out of bounds. Miller, one of only four seniors on this team for Elkin. Elkin coming in on the season 11-3. Their only losses coming to Forbush 20-7, Salisbury 21-10, and Starmount 15-7 on the year. So good team again, number three seed out of the West. So now the Maroon Devils with a nice pass down to Justin Evans at the Elkin 35. We line him up tight on the left side, and we hand off and run that way as well. On the carry is going to be Eric Stevenson. Eric having a good night tonight as well. Talking about that interception a moment ago by Stephen Mercer. That was Stephen's first interception of the season by a secondary that has a bunch of them. Second down now, eight to go from the 33-yard line of Elkin. Scotty McMahon looking to the right side. Coming in with a play over there is going to be Bobby Woods, another of the 19 seniors on this very talented and experienced Maroon Devil football team. All these seniors remember the heartbreak of that 24-22 loss last year at Elkin. And they want revenge here tonight. Handoff right side for a couple of tough ones down to the 30-yard line. Elkin tough in the middle. And on the tackle is going to be, let's see, number 32 among others on the stop, Cole Faulkner on the Elkin defense. So now let's call it third down and five. Just underway, second quarter now, Devils up by 14. We have given up only one touchdown this year in the playoffs. That was last week against Hobton. They broke one big run and scored a few seconds later. Those are the only points scored against this Devil defense throughout this playoff series. So now the Devils tied on the left side. Fake the handoff. Scotty rolls, cuts back inside. He's got pressure, breaks another tackle down to the 25. But from here, he looks to be a hair short, depending on the spot. Depending on the spot. Boy, this is close. They might measure this one, guys and girls. This one is going to be close. The official looks to the sideline. And nope, not even going to measure, huh? Fourth down. They say fourth down and inches, and our Devils are going to go for it. There was never a question about that. But we need a few inches to get a new set of downs to play with here tonight against the Bucking Elks of Elkin in their gold and blue. Handoff left side. Cody spins for the first down and then some. Cody White on that carry goes over 100 yards on the night as he gets five to the 20-yard line. So Cody White spinning for five. And as we mentioned, nobody may be as motivated tonight as Cody White to have a big ball game, and he's already over 100 yards on the ground. Splitting out wide to the left side is Josh Anthony. Officially now, Cody White, 107 yards on the ground tonight with 8:41 to play in the second quarter. Split back, Scotty turns and hands. Cody again, nice hole at the 10, down to the 5, and he's in the end zone. Is there a flag anywhere? No, we don't see one. This one's going to be good. And that is Cody's second touchdown tonight. As we mentioned, a lot of motivation in the heart of number five tonight. 8:32 to go in the first half. 20-0. Nick Zimmerman can make it 3-for-3 on this PAT. Nick's a fun guy to talk to. He's quite an intelligent young man. Good chance to be valedictorian this year at Swain County High School. Ooh, I think Elkin might have blocked that one. The kick was very low, hit the crossbar, and somebody might have got a hand on that PAT. But regardless, the Devils are up 20-0, 8:32 to play. We'll be back. Maroon Devils get to kick it off again to Elkin here. A lot of time left in the first half. 8.5 minutes to go here. And a 20-0 Devil lead. And Zimmerman kicks this one almost back to the field house. I think he was angry because that extra point was no good last time. But anyway, don't forget now, Bryson City Christmas Parade is going to be broadcast this week on Hometown Television. So be sure and tune in for the Bryson City Christmas Parade. You might get to see yourself, okay? And tonight's playoff game is being professionally videotaped using professional three-chip cameras, wireless microphones, and play-by-play by yours truly. It'll also include pregame comments from Coach White, among others, and a portion of the proceeds go back to Swain County High School. Straight ahead, Elkin on the ground, about nine. And we might have a loose football, they say. And the officials might say otherwise. They say it's going to be Elkin football, so don't get excited. But as we mentioned, be sure and get your tape. Because of the support of area businesses, cost for DVD or VHS tape is only $15. You can have it mailed to you for $5. Just call Tammy Mincy, 497-6435, Kent or Cheryl Maxey, 488-1155. Get your tape. And thanks to all Maroon Devil TV supporters. Handoff right side, penalty flag down. Haven't seen many yellow hankies tonight. And that's a good thing. We saw enough last week to last a while. We were penalized 82 yards. That was the only thing we did wrong last week as we pounded Hobton. And I think it was just being pumped up and over-aggressive. As we had some of those last week, our guys were fired up and coming off the line in a hurry all night long. And as the Hobton coach said after the game, the Maroon Devil offensive and defensive lines control the football game, and he was right. Moving back five, the Bucking Elks of Elkin. And they're gold and blue. It's going to bring up first down at about 15 now with 8 minutes to go in this second quarter. Throwing on the run, the quarterback, and it's knocked down and almost intercepted by Josh Anthony. Anthony has 7 on the season. He almost got number 8 right there. He stepped up, and he could see nothing but end zone, I think, on that play. ...25-yard return for a touchdown. Remember now, hopefully the Maroon Devils will be playing at Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh Saturday at 12 noon. We hope you'll make the trip if things go as they're going tonight. Hand off left side. The Elks carry all the way out to the 30-yard line. It's going to be number 34, Chris Martin, a junior, on the bottom of the pile. Let's see who gets up. It's going to be Big Dusty Lossie, among others. Also Cody White on the stop and Jason Boston. Lossie is he's a big guy out there. Dusty, a senior, 6'4", 295. And the guy's in shape because he plays on both sides of the line, offense and defense. And he is quite an anchor on both sides and technique. He gets it done both ways. One spread each way now for Elkin. Rolling to the right is going to be the quarterback, Transo. And he throws. It's going to be complete. Just a short gain at the 34-yard line. Catching the pass over there is going to be Ben Crosswhite. It's going to bring up fourth down, though, and Elkin's going to have to punt it back to the Maroon Devils. And right now, the Elkin offense has not been successful. They've moved the ball a little bit here and there, but nothing consistent on offense as the Devil defense is just shutting down the Elks on offense. 7:10 to go now. We get the ball back here. Not a big rush, low snap. Line drive kind of punt. It's going to be picked up at the 39-yard line. Stepping up, nice return over there by number 25, Stephen Mercer, and gets a few on the return. So the Devils, wait a minute, got a penalty flag down. Let's see what this is about.
Flag on the play.
But we're going to get it in pretty good field position unless we get stung with a big penalty here. In the second quarter now, 7:03 to go. 20-0 Maroon Devils, our score. And the penalty is going to be charged for holding on the return team, so we are going to have to back it up a little bit. So instead of up across the 40, now we're back at the 30. But again, our Maroon Devils have been very effective on offense. Scotty McMahon bringing it in. Gets the call from offensive coordinator Steve Manley, and And what a great job our coaches have done all season. Rod White, Steve Manley, Billy Jenkins, Frank Manley, Tommy Dills, Chuck Collins, James Phillips, Neil Blankenship, Travis Stevenson, Mike Treadway, Michael Watson, and the handoff coming right up the middle. Other coaches, Jeff Marr, Trey Burns, and Craig Barker. All those guys getting it done. Casey Shuler on the carry, knocked down on the play by, looks like, Terry Adams. Terry Adams, a big kid. 6'2", 230, a junior. Not quite as big as Leonard Jordan, though, 6'2", 280. But again, Elkin, basically a team that's looking ahead. Only four seniors on this team, but a good class of sophomores and juniors coming up in Elkin territory, about 3.5 hours away. Devils stay on the ground again, and again, only a couple out to the 35-yard line as Cody White bangs into the Elkin line. And there on the tackle is going to be number 70, Matt Nixon. Matt Nixon, 5'10", 220, a junior. And, you know, it wouldn't surprise me at all if we ran into Elkin again next year. Our Maroon Devils are going to have some guys coming up. Elkin could be a tough team next year as well. These guys, Coach Richard Grissom and Coach Rod White, excellent at getting the most out of their players. Oh, Scotty's in trouble. He's sandwiched, and the ball is loose. Getting on it, though, is a Maroon Devil jersey number 75. Ian McCauley recovers the football, but I'm not sure. Scotty might have been down anyway. He hit the ground, but there is Ian McCauley to recover the football just in case it was a fumble. So for the first time tonight, I believe, we're going to have to punt it. So now we're going to punt, and on is going to be, it's like Devin Smathers on to punt. Big rush by Elkin. They love to block punts. Nice punt by Smathers. Fair catch. And no return there, surprisingly, by Hagen Miller for Elkin. But they get it in good shape with 5:10 to go here in the second quarter.
45-yard line. First and 10 Elkin from the Elks 45.
Frost, pretty thick frost all weekend. Looks like tonight is no difference here in the first weekend of December coming up here. And hopefully the second weekend of December, we'll be playing for a state 1A title in Raleigh. Handoff left side as the Elks run to the 49-yard line. A gain of almost 4 on the play. Looks like number 62, Earl King, on the tackle. Earl King, good to see back in there after having injury problems. Earl getting the job done in the middle along with Jason Boston. Jason, another guy, senior, that's played 3 years and been doing a great job. Second down, we'll call it 6 for Elkin, 4:42 to play. We're in the second quarter here from Swain County Memorial Stadium. Back to throw is going to be Transo. The quarterback throws right side, has his man, first down, quick feet to the 35, all the way to the 30-yard line. Nice job. Finally, dragging him down is going to be Steven Mercer on the tackle. So Mercer on the stop.
Brought down by Mercer.
So all the way to the 30, Elkin. And that may be their best field position of the night. Starting to threaten here just before halftime with 4:27 to play. 20-0 is our score, though. Maroon Devils on top. Elkin has not had the joy of being on the scoreboard yet. In the I formation now, the Elks line them up. They fake. The quarterback tosses, and there's a loose football in the backfield, and the Devils have it at the 33-yard line. It looks like Eric Stevenson might have it. Let's see as they all unpile. So a great play and a bad toss. And getting on it is Eric Stevenson. Stevenson on the football with 4:09 to play. Again, Transo tossed it to the right side. It never made a connection with his tailback. And so we have our second turnover tonight. We have one interception tonight, and now we recover the football. So Elkin on their best drive tonight is going to be shut out on this drive, and the Devils get the football back. So Steven Mercer wide to the right side now. Scotty tosses to the right side. It's going to be big Casey Shuler. He gives a stiff arm, and he knocks him down. Casey at the 45-yard line. What a stiff arm He put a hand right in the face of Keith Whitman, and the stiff arm got him a first down. And that's something a lot of guys don't use as much as they used to back in the days of Jim Brown and some of those great running backs. A stiff arm is a great weapon by a running back. So now at the 45-yard line, it's going to be first down, and they'll spot it actually at the 46-yard line now. 3:51 to go. The Asheville Cougars leading in their playoff game. So good luck to Coach Wilkins and Asheville, along with T.C. Robertson. They're both in their respective 3A and Big 3A in state playoff activity. Cody White to the 47-yard line, a gain of about a yard on the play. On the stop as they all entangle there, and the bottom of the pile is going to be Matt Nixon, who plays left tackle on offense, defensive end on defense, 5'10", 220. So now second down at the 47, clock running, 3:15 and counting, left to play in the second quarter here tonight. As we mentioned, great crowd. Elkin brought a good crowd down from Bucking Elk territory, as we mentioned, about 3.5 hours or so away. Mercer comes in motion back to the line. Scotty hands off. Little misdirection to the 49-yard line of Elkin. So staying on the ground, Cody White knocked down on the play by Donnie Bell.
Ball now marked on about the 49-yard line of the Elks.
Good athletic program at Elkin High School, as we mentioned. Last year, they won the state football championship, the state men's tennis championship, and the wrestling championship. That's a pretty darn good year to win three titles in any sport. So a quality athletic program at Elkin High School. Third down now. Our Maroon Devils need a, we'll call it a short four or a long three, if you will. Mercer in motion, got a penalty flag down. Cody White's in the secondary, but it may come back. Cody White may take it all the way to the house. He's going to be angled in, and he is run out of bounds, but it's not going to matter as the penalty flag is going to be against our Maroon Devils. So all that great run of about 50 yards and then some is going to be coming back. Well, that's not a good sign as we see Josh Anthony, one of our key players, limping off the field. And we hope he's going to be okay. What a great year by Josh, averaging 20 yards on each reception, and he's had 28 receptions. Boy, he's stumbling off. Good thing is he's under his own power. Let's hope he comes back because Josh has one pick tonight. We had motion against the Devils on offense. That's going to set us back and wipe out a gain of over 50 yards by Cody White, who already has over 120 yards rushing tonight. And we're not even at halftime. 2:08 to play. Now, don't forget to get your DVD or VHS tapes of the broadcast, only $15, and you can have it mailed to you only $5. So Hometown Television has it all for you. Third down, we're going to call it almost nine, and we got a penalty flag down. Scotty McMahon pointed a finger like somebody on defense was doing something, but let's see what the officials say. Coach Rod White, what a great career. In 8 years, 70 wins, 31 losses, one tie. He is 19-5 in the playoffs over 6 years. Has one state championship, almost another one last year. Offside against Elkin, so Scotty was right. Somebody jumped on their side of the ball. And that's what really gets the motor running for our Maroon Devils. That loss 24-22 last year against Elkin almost assuredly cost us a state title.
Third and three now for the Maroon Devils.
And all year long, that's kind of been in the back of the mind of these Maroon Devil players, coaches, and fans. So now with 2:08 to go, third down. Going to spot it at the 47. We need three to get a first down here. Cody White, right side, has the first down at the 47 now. 42, check that, 42-yard line of Elkin. So we're beginning to move that football again now. Now we have just over 2 minutes to try to bang it into the end zone and take an even bigger lead into the locker room at halftime.
Ball now,
before a big Maroon Devil crowd, and we hope all this Maroon Devil crowd and then some will travel down to Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh Saturday if this score holds up. Of course, we have a long way to go before you can pull out the party hats. Devils line him up tight on the right side. Scotty back to throw. Straight drop. Timing pattern. Up in the air. It's kind of overthrown, and it's actually intercepted at the 10-yard line. Pass intended down there for Justin Evans, but it's going to be picked off on the play. And if we can see that number, it's going to be 26 on the interception, Will Stewart. So that pass, kind of a timing pattern. Both guys had a shot, and both guys were kind of turned around, and Will Stewart comes down with it for Elkin. But now their problem is they only have a minute 39 seconds to try to do something with it before halftime. And I know Scotty's unhappy with himself. Two interceptions all year, and he has two tonight in the first half. Two tough passes here that were picked off, but hey, the scoreboard is still 20-0. Scotty, don't let that get you down. Hand off left side, Elkin, not a bad run out across the 20-yard line before a bunch of guys led by Jason Boston on defense on the tackle. Nothing new there. Jason's in on a lot of tackles on the season, 54 tackles. Leading our team in the tackle department, of course, Mitchell Green with 67, Craig Autry with 54.
Ball now marked on the 16.
Guys like Jason had 54. Eric Stevenson had 58. Cody White had 61 tackles. A lot of guys getting it done on defense. That's why we're giving up less than 10 points a game. Hand off to the left side. And looks like the Elks get a first down up there on the tackle. Looks like 51, Travis Brooks and company. And we're going to have a timeout, I believe, called by Elkin. Let's see. No, it's going to be called by Swain, actually, with 1:01 to go. That'll stop the clock, and we'll be back. Elkin gets the timeout.
From the Elks. Got 22 nothing with a minute left to go in the third.
Okay, fans, here we go. Final minute of the first half coming at you. Elkin with the football. Rolling to the right is going to be Transone. Throwing on the run. He's got his man on the sideline. Chased out of bounds by Justin Evans, but a nice gain for the Elks as, again, they have their one-minute offense in gear, if you will. Stopping the clock, getting out of bounds with 55 and a half seconds to play. So the Elks coming in this state 1A semifinal. Defending State 1A champions. A lot of pride on the line tonight for them as well. Back to throw. Transo again. Rolling, throwing. Has his man. He's got it again at the 42-yard line. Nice completion. Two in a row. Steven Mercer on the tackle as he hits his man down there, Ben Crosswhite. Now the chains will move, and once the chains are set, the clock will start again. Right now it's at 48.9 seconds to go in the half. And our defense has got to stop Elkin and keep them out of the end zone. Now they get the chain set at the 43 of Swain. And looks like we had a whistle before the play even got underway. But talking about Elkin and Swain, Swain, one of the largest 1A teams in the state with 543 students. Elkin with 357 students in the 1A division, so a difference of almost 200 students there. Our Maroon Devils are right on the verge of being kicked up into 1AA. And every year that can change with the average daily membership, they call it, the ADM, which is the number of students in the school. Back to throw, Transo has plenty of time, throws back, and it's going to be caught down there by Hagen Miller. Another first down, stops the clock with 38.2 seconds. They mark it at the 25. So Elkin with their best field position tonight in Maroon Devil territory here. But the clock a factor now, 38 seconds to play. Elkin looks like with one timeout left. And they're going to call it right here.
The Elks will have a first and 10 on the Maroon.
To the timeout, the Elkin Bucking Elks trying to get on the scoreboard before halftime. Rolling again, it's going to be Transo, and he's brought down in a big sack. Coming in there on defense is number 61, Mitchell Green, one of the captains on this football team. Mitchell. Stopping the clock at 28 seconds to play. Elkin calls another timeout.
28.8, ball resting on the 35-yard line.
Their last one. We have 28.8 seconds to play. And now they're at the 35-yard line. Got to keep them on the zero end of the scoreboard. Back to throw, Transo, and it's going to be, is it intercepted? It was close down at the 15. And no. Stephen Mercer was there. He might have picked it off the top of the ground. Boy, that was close. Boy, that was close. Good job down there as well. He already has one pick tonight. He almost got another one. 20 seconds now on the incomplete pass. Elkin now with a third down. They still need about 19 to go from the 35. They got to get down to the 15 for a first down. And again, they're out of timeouts. Swain fans on their feet here. Got to get the defense revved up. A three-man front now by the Maroon Devil defense. Got four men coming out to the quarterback. And they're coming after him. He misses one guy, throws down on the sideline. He's got a man. Only a short gain at the 24-yard line, out of bounds, but it stops the clock. 11.4 seconds to play here. Pass complete to Wells Stewart. Just inside the marker down there, but it's going to bring up fourth down. So now two big problems for Elkin. They have a fourth down and eight coming up, and the clock with only 11 and a half seconds to go before halftime. And not only that against them, but this outstanding defense giving up only 8.8 points a game. Those three factors are not a whole lot of fun, but they're going to try a field goal. They're going to spot it at the 32. It'll be a 42-yard field goal. On the kick is going to be Wells Stewart. Wow, he's got it, but it's not even close. Not even close. It's wide.